my God, Ryan's Boba Fett.
Boba Fett.
Ryan, are you Boba Fett?
For now. Now I'm a crazy robot.
You're
Oh my God.
This is not canon.
Get the droidekas up here.
So they eventually just patched in the prequel shit into this game. Is what I'm getting the sense of.
This game, when did the last prequel come
out? I wouldn't call anything that you're seeing here particularly representative of what Star Wars Galaxy
was. It was 99, 2000,
yeah, kind of hard to tell. Right?
Yeah.
Yes. So this came out after the second movie, before the third.
But this is a set, obviously, in the what, between Empire Strikes Back and
One
Return
and two,
of the Jedi?
Between Star Wars and the Empire Strikes Back.
Yeah.
Is what we've been told.
But there's barely any time between those two.
Well, you don't know.
There is, like, but there's no years. Death Star.
No, because remember they see the bounty hunter on...
There's 3 years, yeah.
On, what do you call it?
Or Mandel.
Guys, I'm pretty
or
big.
Mandel.
But it's just weird that they have this Old Republic tech walking around.
I thought you were going to...
Yeah.
Somewhere. I thought there was some event somewhere that you were going to go...
Probably the
I've been to like 8 different planets while you guys are talking about pirating
when I
MMOs
left,
in the 90s.
You were on Tatooine, and that was like 5 hours ago, and you're right back here
I
talking to Jabba
Hutt. I haven't in hours.
Oh.
But and I look back, and you're doing the exact same shit. Bib Fortuna, flying bug creature guy.
Right.
He's a Nemoidian.
What?
He's a Nemoidian. They're immune to Jedi powers.
Okay. All right, guys, we've got Dude Baca on the line. Dude!
Baca.
Dude, what's up?
What's going on, man? How you doing?
The end of the world. Be cool.
It's not bad so far. Where are you at? Are you on Tatooine?
Yeah, I'm in front of Dude Fortuna. He's turning me into some dude in a rainbow robe. I have no idea who it is.
Yeah, I've got some awful costume going on right now. I can't even see myself
costume
anymore.
Oh my God, you're in a game.
I'm a giant Jawa now.
I can't figure out how to take the costume off, so I can't change the style.
Oh, right underneath your little profile in the upper left, there's a little icon. If you click on that, that's the costume, and you can remove that. Otherwise, it'll just automatically remove in like a half hour. But I'm gonna roll around as this giant Jawa. Did you see the thing about Coronet?
The Coronet?
Yeah.
It's kind of a pain in the ass to get anywhere. So I kind of don't want to travel, but if there's shit there, then we should probably go there.
I'm saying, like, we've seen this, and this is good craziness over here. I like seeing this X-Wing just hanging out in the fucking air next to this oversized Wampa. Which, oh yeah, it's hanging out right over the Sarlacc pit.
The Wampa is in the Sarlacc pit.
That's a sex act right
there. Yeah, you shouldn't have Wampas near your Sarlacc pit.
It's like a giant urinal.
It's not going to be any good. Dude, you got any questions? You just want... Just want to call in and say what's up.
I don't know. How's Star Wars Galaxies?
It's kind of retarded.
Hey, be nice.
Yeah, I agree.
But not bad. I don't know. I'm having fun with it. I'm enjoying the way the devs are just throwing ridiculousness at it right now. So.
Pretty good way to end the game. I'm a robot now.
Terrific. Now, you had said you hadn't actually played this game a ton, right?
No, not really. Like, 2 years ago, I was subscribed for a month. And then when I re-upped my subscription to get in on the end, it gave me 2 years worth of veteran rewards.
Awesome.
So I got that a whole bunch of shit that I think I sold because I didn't really care.
Camels.
Oh, that thing went away.
It's space camels.
I also lost my old character, so I had to make this guy twice.
Okay.
That's
cool.
All right, dude. I think I'm going to go to Coronet. If you want to come with, that's cool.
All right.
Coronet or Coruscant?
Oh, wait, let's see what... I'm going to talk to Rotha a little bit more. He's over here at the Sarlacc party. He was that dude, that op. Let's see if he has anything to say.
Yeah, we really want to see you talk to people.
All right, Dude Baca, thanks for calling in. I'll see you on Tatooine.
I think I got knocked down.
It's okay,
get up again?
Get back up.
We got to speak to the Dude Baca.
Yeah.
It's pretty awesome.
Yeah. Brother of Chewbacca.
Yeah. Pretty exciting stuff.
Bro. Oh.
Bro.
Yes.
Alright. What if there are any all Wookiee guilds? You think they have like a
on the RP server, I'm sure.
Nothing but Wookiees.
Must be nothing but Wookiees.
Yeah.
They just speak in
taking that cushion.
Yeah. And they all have they just have one big yacht and they just go around doing whatever.
Oh, man, I can't imagine what their mumble server is like.
This is probably a fetish guild.
Oh, they're probably still on TeamSpeak, who am I kidding?
Yeah.
Galaxies. That is the biggest Ugnaught I've ever seen.
What, you got something against TeamSpeak?
No, man, I'm down with TeamSpeak. I got Ventrilo, too. I can do it all. Wow. Mumble, Ventrilo, TeamSpeak. I even Skype.
There's an iPhone app for TeamSpeak now.
Really?
Yeah.
That is bizarre.
So you can TeamSpeak from your iPhone.
That actually almost makes sense.
It's a legitimate thing in the store, not even like some jailbreak nonsense. It's
That's awesome.
It's a real thing, yeah.
TeamSpeak's coming back, man.
Yeah, I know that the couple of Old Republic guilds that we have going in our community, they are running TeamSpeak servers. And I only bring it up because my Trackmania server host added the option for, hey, if you've got a TeamSpeak server that you want to use, you can
auto-connect.
We got a plug-in thing that'll promote the TeamSpeak server from your server.
What are the Trackmania people going to come up with next, man?
It's amazing. I know. That's where the real innovation is happening right now.
I mean, I wish there was some sort of Trackmania MMO.
I think Trackmania is, those servers can hold up to 200 players. So.
Okay. So all we need is, less driving and more pew-pew.
Yeah.
Bullseye of Womp Rat. Bullseye. Oh, dear.
Oh, man. You just blew up some dude's house.
Yeah. Player housing, too. They're pretty pissed.
And trees. And then a Corellian Corvette freighter.
I'm not gonna lie, this game does not look super exciting.
Has not aged super well.
No.
Early MMOs.
Yeah.
Because it's an 8-year-old MMO, you guys.
I'm not saying. I'm just saying the things that you were doing do not look particularly compelling activities to have.
No, it feels like a very generic MMO in a lot of ways.
Well, at least you're flying around and like it's not.
Yeah, except for the part where I'm flying around. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Is this how you get to that other planet you're going to? What are you doing?
Someone's shooting me.
Engage hyperspace.
That seems bad.
You can't do that in atmosphere, dude. That'll kill the whole planet.
The game's over tonight, man. Fuck the planet.
Game over, man. Game over. You know, it'd be kind of interesting if they teamed up with BioWare to actually have some send-off event in this and carry over. Yeah.
That would require acknowledging that this is still a game.
Well, no, it would have, but, like, think how cool that would have been.
Yeah.
Like, you get some, like, vanity pet or achievement or something in the Old Republic.
I survived
for
the
being...
end of Star Wars Galaxies.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It would just be like the last night of Monday Nitro when Chain of Man was on. Yeah, totally.
Well, the new the Old Republic is not SOE, is it?
It is EA and Lucas is obviously involved, but originally they were more involved and EA bought them out in a lot of aspects, so it's mostly
shoot
EA
that guy.
We've got Javier from Chile on the line.
Javier!
Yeah, hello guys.
How's it going?
Well, I just wanted to pitch in. I'm probably your most southern listener ever, so here I am.
That's pretty south. What's your question today, sir?
Well, first thing, I just wanted to say thank you for all the time I can get free from you guys. I should subscribe, but if I subscribed, I would probably stay online on the computer watching videos all day and get nothing done.
Well, that sounds okay. You should do that, man.
Check that out, man. I don't know.
That sounds like a good way to handle yourself.
Yeah. So I just use the free stuff. So I really enjoy it. So thank you for that.
Fair enough.
And I actually wanted to comment real quickly. Well, two things. First one is that I find it interesting that I'm watching this because it's the first time I get to watch anything about Star Wars Galaxies. Because I used to live in Argentina and I remember wanting to play this game when it came out. Because it sounded great, amazing. I love Star Wars and everything. And Sony wouldn't take my money because I'm sort of some dirty South American and I didn't even want my money. So, no, you can't play the game.
Which I've heard that about South Americans, really.
Yeah.
It's always weird. It's always odd when like, just bad, weird facts about the real world bump up against the internet.
Yeah,
because you assume like, yeah, everyone's on here. It doesn't matter where you're from. You should be able to get to the same shit that I can get to. And then you realize, wait, a lot of this stuff is region restricted.
And they didn't make the licensing arrangements right to be playable in different regions.
But even like credit cards, like half of Europe has credit cards that we can't use.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, there's also legality issues too. Like if you try to put out a game on Steam and you're in Germany and then you don't meet the blood standards or whatever, you can get a lot of trouble for
the blood standards.
The blood standard.
Sounds like a nice new awesome hardcore movie. Band.
Yeah.
But it seems like Sony and SOE is especially bad at it. Like I nothing that was on SOE I could play. The Matrix Online I couldn't play. EverQuest I couldn't play anything. Ever.
So basically it's your fault is what you're saying, which I agree with. I'm sorry.
No, that's that is shitty. It's one of those things that you would think that we would be past by now. Just societally that it wouldn't happen anymore.
One big country, I think.
One
the world
big
needs.
Country. Yeah.
I don't know why we need money anymore, man. We should just trade like
when
chickens.
When the new world overtakes, when my chemtrails do what they're going to do, and there is a one world government and one world currency,
people who don't believe
this
in MMOs
will go away.
They'll be in the FEMA camps. That's where you put people who do that. Kind
exactly.
Of shit,
if man. You don't want to play an MMO, you get in the FEMA camps, and it's basically
FEMA camps. Really?
It's Gitmo for kids. So sign up for any MMO if you want to stay out of that.
So you're saying Kidmo?
Kidmo. Yeah.
Google Ron Paul.
Google Ron Paul. That's all I'm saying.
thanks for calling in, sir.
See you, Javier.
Thank you.
I love your pod racer. That is way, you're way higher up than he was in the movie, though.
Yeah.
In the movie, he was right in the middle of that
shit. Oh, this is a different model of a pod racer,
man.
This is like 20 years later, too. This is like an Edsel. In New Republic. Yeah.
Well, so pod racing apparently, according to lore within Star Wars Galaxies, pod racing became outlawed.
By the Empire?
I don't know.
Pod Dicks. Racing is outlawed, only outlaws will have pod racers.
I think that's the idea.
You can have my pod racer when you pry it from my cold dead fingers.
Uh-huh. A lot of fireworks going off. Is that
you got a third for that one, Jeff?
National Podcast.
I'd rather
pod racer
be judged by 12 than carried by pod racer.
All right, that'll do.
That was close.
Matt, what are you saying? What's up?
Are you going to, let's see now. If Snake Eyes 32-something, even if WoW isn't the best-looking MMO, do you think its art style has kept it from aging so rapidly, and is that an asset that they can carry on forward for the next few years? I personally say yes. Their art style has... It was technically proficient when it came out, but it has aged really well. Obviously, they update a lot of models, but...
Well, the kind of cartoony stuff ages really well. Does,
so. I think that's an area where Old Republic's going to do really well over time as well, because it's... I mean, it's definitely like... It's a higher spec game than World of Warcraft is, obviously. Yeah. You'd expect that. But it's not super high spec or anything like that, and the art style has a lightly kind of cartoonish look to it that I think will age just fine.
It's the Nintendo effect.
Kind of, yeah. It's the Pixar effect or something.
Your effectual incident.
I just got an email from Sony saying, this is just a friendly reminder. You've had funds in your PSN wallet that have not been used for 6 months or more. I don't know.
Spend your money with us! Oh, God!
I feel like I just bought something, but maybe there's just, like, funds that have been sitting there. I feel like I just bought something on PSN. So this, I don't know.
Or maybe your account got hacked again.
Right, yeah, I know.
Spammer sending.
Yeah, I was gonna say maybe that's just.
Oh yeah, it is totally fake.
A phishing email.
Yeah, this is totally a phishing email. Looks nice though. Well, wait a minute, because
a phishing email?
It has my PSN account name in it.
That doesn't mean it's not. Your PSN account name has been on the internet for 6 months now.
Yeah. But all the stuff is coming from PlayStation-email.com.
That's a phishing email.
Yeah. Yeah, this is not Sony at all. That's interesting.
Congratulations.
It's been refreshed.
To view your account balance, please sign in.
What the hell is Coronet? I've never heard of Coronet before.
This is like the Capital Planet.
Oh. They're the nice ones that have the flowery print on them.
The plate won't collapse when you put chili on it?
Yeah.
Who the fuck puts chili on a paper plate? That seems like a recipe for chili in your lap.
If a paper plate's all you got, what are you going to do?
Get a paper bowl.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Eat chili right out of the bowl?
That doesn't seem good.
Out of the pot?
Yeah. What? Oh, I thought you were skydiving for a second.
Rave?
No, this is a giant Star Destroyer that's over Coronet right now.
Eh. That's probably fine.
As long as they don't fire the turbo lasers.
Not the turbo lasers.
Man, I still really liked Star Wars a lot when this game came out. Now I don't really like Star Wars at all.
Yeah. Actually, I didn't really like Star Wars when this game came out either, so.
I remember, maybe I liked Star Wars when this game was kind of building. You know,
like
when
the thought of it?
I liked the idea of an original three episodes.
Use your words.
I think the last positive Star Wars experience I had.
Thanks, Ryan Davis.
Like just unqualified success was probably TIE Fighter.
The last unqualified success I had with Star Wars, TIE Fighter, X-Wing Alliance was okay, in retrospect. At the time, I was bummed out by it.
Yeah, at the time, it was a bummer, but
like
it panned out okay.
Yeah, you just couldn't run on any machines that were available at that time.
Yeah.
But like a year and a half later, it was awesome.
Dark Forces, I guess?
All the way through Jedi Academy, those games were okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I thought KOTOR was okay for what
yeah,
it was.
Yeah,
so I love
yeah,
KOTOR.
Certainly. KOTOR. Yeah. But still, that's that. I'm still gonna say that TIE Fighter was a higher high water mark than even KOTOR. That's
yes.
That is my
no, I
that is
that.
The best Star Wars thing, is TIE Fighter, and then followed closely by X-Wing.
Well, especially when Rory went and ruined KOTOR 2 at Obsidian.
Yeah, that was Rory.
I mean, yeah, that was all Rory.
Yeah, he worked at Obsidian. I thought he wasn't.
I thought he was there after that. Okay.
I think it was during or. Was he there?
No, he was there well after that. He was there pretty much for Alpha Protocol and
Neverwinter Nights 2, right? Yeah. I found a business card for Rory's when I was going through my pile of business cards, cleaning off my desk at home. At some point, I met him probably on a show floor or something
Matthew
someplace.
Rory.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, we interviewed him at PAX.
That's funny.
And I had meetings with him at E3 and stuff like that to see games. And I'm like, I know you.
Those are always funny meetings, right?
Yeah.
We used to sit next to each other. How's it going, man?
So, Metacris wants to know, what's your favorite art style in an MMORPG?
I don't know, man.
Impressionist.
Pointillism.
Sumi-E ink, you know? Kind of
that was much more esoteric than either Ryan or mine.
Do you think it works better if they have kind of a stylized art style
anime?
Instead of, like...
Traditional throat singing?
I think having some sort of stylized look to it that's gonna carry because I mean these games have to last theoretically
four years, eight years,
however long they're gonna go, and you're not gonna be able to make all the engine updates and keep it high tech that whole time. Mm-hmm.
Well, you can't make the art updates is the larger. I mean,
yeah.
Just the volume. Like if
right.
you look at what
you
they did with Cataclysm and
right.
WoW, that's amazing. Mm-hmm. Nobody's done. I mean. Like when EverQuest, the original EverQuest updated their graphics,
right.
they just replaced all the player characters.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Kind of not the.
Not a redesign of the main world. Yeah.
We have Baltimore on the phone.
Baltimore.
Hello, gentlemen.
Talk to me.
Baltimore have crabs?
Sure.
What can we do for you today, sir?
Well, two quick questions for you. One, as somebody who has tried MMOs about 4 or 5 times, I haven't been able to get hooked at all. What makes these things so much fun? And my second question is, acid.
I don't think you get a second question.
Oh.
Try again,
you're breaking up there.
Okay, sorry. If SOPA passes, how is that going to affect you guys?
We'll be closed by the end of the night. This
will
it'll
be both the end of Star Wars Galaxies and Giant Bomb.
Yep. Couldn't have one without the other.
I don't think anyone really knows. It's
it'll get locked up in court for so long that it's
a lot of that
have,
stuff seems so theoretical. Obviously it's bad. Like, we are against it.
We bought giantbomb.ly today, so we're gonna move the whole thing to Libya.
Yeah.
Home of free speech and free internet. Libya.
I don't think it's very easy to predict like what impact that would have.
Yeah,
have
I don't think it necessarily has the immediate impact on fair use laws and fair use stuff as
it's
it
all
could,
the user generated
so.
Stuff is the big problem. I mean,
yeah.
The big thing that's fucked up about SOPA is the way that they're changing the safe harbor provisions of the DMCA.
Right.
So right now, if say somebody posts some copyright infringing content on Giant Bomb or one of our sites that has a wiki, then the people who own the copyright can send us a DMCA takedown, and we have a limited period of time to respond to that and either take it down or not take it down. But we're protected by the law from penalties against us.
Right.
With SOPA, what happens basically is they pull the plug on your domain. Until you clean it up.
Yeah.
Which is internet death sentence. It's really boring stuff. I'm sorry. I apologize. Yeah, yeah. But he brought it up, not me, man.
Yeah.
It's bad news.
Baltimore.
Call your congressman,
Jeez.
Baltimore.
Yes, call your congressman.
Most of them are idiots.
Yeah, already done.
Right, and as for the other question, it seems person to person, it can vary for what makes an MMO click. For me, it's always been a critical mass of people that I know, of friends playing the game.
That's it for me.
Yeah, it's kind of got to be the social aspect of it combined with you. Kind of, I feel like it preys upon the most addictive portions of your personality in a lot of ways.
Yep.
It becomes that sort of thing where. Like, you care about building this character. You care about getting more stuff for your dude and becoming the best version of said dude that you can be.
Well, for me, it was about, like, I love the raid puzzles. Like, those big 25, and EverQuest 1 was like 70 people, raid encounters. You have those, like, this massive scale of teamwork, which I know doesn't appeal to some people, but like, I really like that. But I just don't like the other massive amount of time that goes into making that stuff happen. I don't have time for that, so I play single player shit now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, stuff like that, Baltimore. Thanks for calling.
Cool. Thank you, guys.
Yep. See ya.
What I have a question from Wiseblood.
Clicking on that ship there a lot.
Do you think that a Fallout Online is ever going to actually happen, and what are your thoughts on a potential Fallout MMO?
I think if we do see any kind of online Fallout, it's going to be in an MMO format. I mean, it's no secret that they've been trying to crack that for a little bit with Elder Scrolls and put an MMO together for that. I don't think the next Fallout game that we see is going to be online, but... Yeah, I think if they can figure out how to do Elder Scrolls, much like they've done with the single player stuff, Fallout probably won't be too far behind, provided they can work out the rights to it. Because that was the whole thing: is Interplay still had the rights to make a Fallout MMO, and then there was lawsuits involved in that. That'll probably get worked out one way or the other. But you know, I imagine that if there's money to be made there, the people that are holding that up and preventing that from being a thing will quickly find some sort of common ground for it. But probably not anytime soon, so I wouldn't go pre-order that just yet.
Is this a DX7 or a DX8 game?
I don't think this is a DX game.
It has to be a DX game.
I don't think they had invented DirectX.
No, that was in 99. This has to be a DX game.
Why?
Because.
Why does it have to?
Probably it's OpenGL only.
Oh, man. If it was OpenGL only, it would be on the Mac by now.
Right. Well, that's a hot-looking tree.
Yeah.
Pasquale says it is 9C.
Okay.
So.
They are not taking advantage of the full spectrum of features offered by DirectX 9C.
Such as?
Dot product, dot bump mapping, shading.
Oh, there's shading. I just had a lot of stuff turned on. You want to see what this looks like when I turn everything up?
Yeah, turn it up.
It does not look great. I'm just going to say that up front.
So you're saying it looks better with everything turned down?
Yeah, I stepped back on a few keys.
Turn it all the way up.
Yeah, pump this thing up.
Hold on. We lost a server.
Oh, all right.
The server crashed.
While that happens, we've got Jared from Saskatoon up on the line. Yeah. What's happening in Saskatoon?
I am watching you guys play Star Wars Galaxies, and I am totally transfixed.
Okay.
Don't you
this is the most exciting thing to hit Saskatoon since... something that hasn't happened yet.
Since the Sons of Prozac, that's been the last important thing to happen in all of Saskatchewan.
I don't want to think about that.
Yeah, no one does. What's on your mind? You got a question?
Yeah, I do. So I've played pretty much every kind of genre of game that I could think of in my, you know, many years of gaming. And I just realized, you know, an MMO is basically something I've never really tried. Although I did try World War II Online a couple times when it was, you know, like free trials and such. And so my question kind of is, in the world of like action MMOs, like you were talking about Planetside earlier and whatever, do you really think that all the kind of stuff that all the stuff that you get out of having...
Get to the question, Jesus Christ, man. This is the longest preamble.
I'm sorry, sir.
We are falling asleep.
My apologies, sir.
TLDR.
My apologies, sir. Just question is, do you think that, like, the massive multiplayer-ness of a action MMO is really necessary?
Is it necessary?
In the sense that... a game like a 64-player game of Battlefield, there's so many things going on. Does having that extra amount of people really do anything to improve?
Yeah, it creates chaos, and chaos is what you want. It's that randomness that makes that stuff work. Yeah, I think so.
I think that does go a long way, and it allows you to bring some sort of sense of additional scale and weight to the proceedings, you know, and that's something that games like MAG and other stuff like that haven't truly been massive have been able to kind of pull off. But that notion that, like, your actions affect the entire world around you, I think it is something that is potentially super exciting.
But it's persistent. I mean, that like it's yeah. always all like that. You log off and stuff still keeps happening. That's rad.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I think an MMO is maybe, kind of the last kind of holy grail of kind of figuring that stuff out. You know, we've had games that have had smaller individual conflicts on servers and smaller servers that have then gone on to have some sort of persistence. Stuff like Mag.
Yeah. But or Planetside. I mean,
Planetside was...
You took off with my drink.
Well, you kind of even hope that like that kind of stuff would make its way to games like Battlefield. And like that. I think that's the right. next natural evolution for Call of Duty, is away from the meta experience bar, if there's some sort of persistent conflict, although that could end up being a real debacle, so who knows.
I think that was stuff that, you know, the big rumor is that was some of the stuff that they were talking about for Battlefield 3 before it became what it became, but, yeah, it's...
But that's the challenge, right? Is balancing the sense of scale, like a big environment, something that seems huge, but without having to spend a lot of time in the middle of fucking nowhere by yourself. It's like you want it to seem big, but then you want to naturally be able to kind of cluster people into specific areas where there's like actual action happening.
Well, there's a shitload of time in MMOs that you're basically spending like standing around waiting for either other people to log on or for them to get to the place where they need to be. Or there's always that guy that's like, oh man, I'll be right there, but I'm gonna go run turn in this quest. And then 45 minutes later, you're like, dude, really? Are you gonna?
I mean, and by that time, you know, the other dude in Iron Forge has left his keyboard.
And he's like, I gotta go to bed. It's 3 o'clock in the morning, man.
Yeah.
It turns out people don't want to waste their time.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That's totally why I had the preamble, because I just want to make it clear. Like, I totally understand that everyone wants to be a hero, right? You want to get in there and you want to be getting the most kills. You want to be doing all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, that's kind of the difficulty is to have that kind of great scale. You kind of run into the problem where there's not a way for everyone to be that. And there's so many things going on that it's very much possible to feel like you are, I don't mind being a support guy or something, but it feel possible that you feel like you're a cog in a machine and you're not really accomplishing anything.
Just like real war, man. Just like real war.
It's almost like you just described all video games ever.
Well, yeah. You online, man.
I mean, if
like a cog in the machine.
If you want to get too profound about it, it's like, what did you accomplish? Nothing. You finished a game. And if you're playing an MMO, you never finished the game.
My life.
You play, you experience something, and then that was that. You know, nothing further. That's always the thing that makes me stop playing MMOs. Like whenever I have picked back up, I've always like gone at it for a while, and I'm gonna go see some new stuff, go around and kill some new shit, and then you realize, fuck. I'm gonna level up, and I'm gonna see a blue version of the enemy that I saw 10 levels ago.
Blue.
Right? You know, I'll grind against the same kind of stuff.
What kind of blue?
And the state of the world will never change. I can rise and fall a million times, and this world will always be this world, regardless of what I do. And existential crisis fills me when I start making those realizations.
You can just play the game and not think about that shit so much.
Yeah.
That's the only way that I stay in there as long as I do.
There's so much downtime in a lot of those games, though, that you have plenty of time to let the real world creep in.
Yeah, when I'm running to my corpse... For 30 minutes.
You hook up an Xbox next to the place where you play the PC, so you can play other games during the downtime.
Or just play other games all the time.
Maybe do both the same, multi.
Okay, I will not play MMOs.
Yeah,
that works too. Now get back to playing this MMO. Thanks, Saskatoon.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
My favorite part about this is that as Ryan has played more of this game, he's become the apologist for it, just by virtue of him being the one that's playing it.
Right.
What, Star Wars Galaxies?
Yeah.
No, not at all.
I can tell you love this game, man. Just admit it. It's okay.
These next 2 hours are going to be grueling for you because you're going to be fighting back tears the whole time.
I know.
I love...
You have that t-shirt underneath your shirt that says, I heart Star Wars Galaxies, and then it's a picture of Boba Fett.
Let's not talk about the shirt you're wearing under there, so... Yeah.
That's right.
Come on. People want to know.
Got to save something for after dark.
I don't know. We might need to find something else to do because the server's not coming back up.
Is there another server? Or is there only one left at this point?
No, that's the only one that I have a character on, man.
Did we get the time zone wrong? Maybe it was going down at 9 o'clock Central Time.
No, I believe we got the timing right.
All
right.
The words "Star Wars Galaxies status" and it just came up with a "Hey, thanks for playing."
But that page has been like that all day.
So it's not.
Yeah. Is this going to be like the Xbox thing where five people are logged in and they can't turn off the servers until those people die?
I mean, I got an email directly from SOE PR that said, like, yes, we are closing at 9 p.m. Pacific time.
Do they endorse this activity that you're doing? Or
they
definitely helped make it possible.
They shout out, both on the Matrix Online and Star Wars Galaxies, SOE PR has been nothing but top shelf in getting us access and
that's awesome.
And make sure that that we can do what we want to do during these kind of end times, which, you know, like they don't need to. Like, there's no reason. That
there's no benefit.
Yeah, there's very little benefit other than the goodwill here. Like, we're going to run in and kind of, you know, poke fun at, but also it's partially poking fun at, but also kind of trying to find out what it was that kept people playing this game for so long. Well, this is an 8-year-old MMO. This is a game that people have been, someone has been actively playing for 8 years.
But people have somehow been talking shit about it for 9.
So, of course.
Well, but they've been talking about shit about the Old Republic for longer than that, so.
Oh, wait, hold on. There we go.
Oh, wow, we're back here.
All right.
Thank goodness.
So I have a question from our intern, Ben.
Ben?
He asks, are MMOs going to die out and make an eventual return like most other genres of games, or is the hardcore PC audience that exists for it going to make that not the case?
I think as long as people have money that they will throw at a game that they are already playing, you will continue to find that, mm-hmm. Whether it be, you know, I think the definition of MMO will probably change a lot, and it already has, but you'll see a lot of cases where, you know, free-to-play games are picking up some of that slack already, and, you know, social games and mobile games and stuff like that kind of expanding into things that were traditionally that kind of hardcore PC audience. I think the definition of what makes an MMORPG is really going to continue to change. And that stuff will really never totally go away. The era of the big budget MMO, I think, remains to be seen, and that could stay or go. We'll see. I don't know.
Hey, the International Space Station's flying over in 2 minutes.
Again?
Really? Again.
Did it just fly over?
Every day. Twice today.
Weird.
Polar orbit, man. Science.
So, but why is it flying over here today?
It flies over every place on Earth every day.
Not in every place.
That's a lot of places.
Within view of every place on Earth every day.
Sure.
You can't see it.
So does the moon and the sun.
Yeah, but you can't see it because of where the sun... It doesn't matter. This is the worst conversation we've ever had. It's really saying something.
All right, what do I have here?
I thought you were going to turn up the graphics.
Yeah.
320 by 240, what?
That broke the server last time you tried it, man. I want to see some of that
fire. We should keep doing that.
Wow, then. Look at that sky. It's a hell of a sky.
Look at that sky. It's kind of cool.
I can see my house from here.
Except for the part where it doesn't make any sense.
Well, it's a hurricane, man.
Yeah.
Upside down.
Okay.
It's like the day after tomorrow. It's pulling air from the stratosphere down to the earth, and that dude's going to run away from the weather, and then somebody's going to freeze solid.
All right.
Also, there's a mall.
Is that the mall there, the building there in the background?
Why not? Okay. The mall's probably buried under a sand dune.
Oh.
You can't see them all, but you're going to be walking, and the glass is going to crack, and all of a sudden, I don't remember who was
in off the
that.
Line will happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where are you now?
Tatooine.
It's back to Tatooine. The sand looks different to me.
This is Nar Shaddaa.
Are you just making up words now?
Is this Dantooine? There are witches there. I learned that from The Force Unleashed.
Huh.
That was also not a very good Star Wars game.
Yeah, it had a lot of potential.
Like
the physics and stuff. Like it was a really great demo.
First level was really good.
Yeah.
In that factory, you had to pull the TIE fighter out and smack.
Yeah.
That's rad.
Mm-hmm. The Darth Vader bit.
Yeah.
There with the front of it was really cool.
And then they had force resistant enemies, and then it just destroyed what that game was about.
There's a lot of Star Wars games with really awesome first levels. Dark Forces had an amazing first level because that was where you stole the Death Star plans.
Right.
You were the spy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That was a great level. That was a pretty cool game.
What was the second one? Jedi Knight. That one.
Yeah.
That game was just awesome. No, Jedi Outcast was was the Quake Engine one, right?
Jedi Outcast was Jedi Knight 2, wasn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Jedi Dark Knight Forces was Dark Forces 2. Was,
yep. Jedi Knight.
And that uses, like, some weird LucasArts engine that they also used for Outlaws right. or something, right?
Yeah. And then they split everything. Yeah. Yeah. It just became, like, Hexen and Heretic and all that stuff where yeah. they're just like, we got this, so now we're calling it, this is Heretic 2. Like, well, no, you can't do that.
Franchise
like, Beyond, overload. Beyond Hexen. Hexen Beyond Heretic, and then Hexen and then Heretic,
and then Heretic 2 was third person, and it was awesome. That game was really good.
Well, it was third person.
Don't hate Heretic 2, man. I don't know if we can get past this. That was the first. That was it. Had mouse control for a third person game. You could move the camera freely.
Yeah, that was.
It came out the same week as Half-Life, so nobody ever played it. I think Sin came out the week before, right?
Yeah.
Then it was like Heretic 2 and Half-Life. I fucked that week up so bad on all fronts because I bought Sin the week before.
Yeah.
And then I bought Heretic 2 instead of Half-Life. And I was the saddest dude ever. Because
I backed
like,
Sin because the multiplayer demo, that multiplayer level in the demo they put out was so much fun.
They had the dam that took 17 minutes to load.
Yeah.
That bank heist level at the beginning.
Yeah, yeah. That first level of Sin is great. Every level past that, not so good. But
no.
That first level.
Load times.
I'd almost still rather play that than Half-Life 1.
You need to go back and play both of those. You should play Sin.
Yeah.
Dalkan Kurora wants to know, what elements from other genres do you think could help improve MMOs in the future?
Are the colors on this messed up? The colors on this are messed up.
No, he changed his HUD template.
I changed the HUD a while ago, but I'm also turning on all the shadow effects.
Oh, okay. All right. Mm-hmm. What elements from other games would work in MMOs?
Yeah,
I mean, you know, a lot of them. You know, it's the action, the movement in an MMO is traditionally not the strong point.
Collision.
You know? Yeah, collision and all that sort of stuff, yeah. And physics, and you know, I think a lot of the things that modern games do to feel snappy are things that MMOs are bad at because of the inherent nature of how those games work.
A lot of that's the tech trade-offs where the collision system. You know, it takes a fair amount of CPU to do correctly, which you can have on the client side, but when you're, you know, serving even on 100 or 200 servers, and you have to calculate
nice
that collision
shadow.
For every single object that the server's managing, it just doesn't work out too well.
This looks a lot better. Well, it looks better.
Yeah, this is cranked all the way up here.
And why did you turn it down?
Frame rate.
Yeah, so I'm sorry, if you can't get 60 frames a second
yeah.
on an 8-year-old game.
Yeah, man. Like, what is this PC?
Well, okay, so but let's go back to the server thing. This is interesting.
Sure.
Like, because you worked on some of this stuff, right? At some point?
I did, yes.
So on an MMO, typically they run, like, all the collision and all the physics stuff and all that stuff happens server side, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, because otherwise stuff get, like, clients get out of sync and weird things happen.
Right.
And bad right. news. So that's why we don't have good collision on most MMOs.
Right. So think about what a lot of people have been doing for the last couple years is that the client, the game client is just a window into your character.
Mm-hmm.
Like, think of like VNC or like remote desktop or something like that.
Okay.
And how you have like this kind of thin client that's a view onto another box.
Okay.
It's kind of the same thing.
Okay.
Where your client is rendering the graphics and showing you the presentation and whatnot, but you're controlling an object that's in a simulation that's happening somewhere else.
So you're saying MMOs are just fancy database viewers?
Not database viewers, like simulated world viewers.
Okay.
DARPA actually is very interested in MMOs, or at least they were like 5 or 10 years ago.
For training purposes?
For training purposes,
gold farming?
For global thermonuclear war
okay.
simulation purposes.
That sounds fun.
Yeah.
Virtual chemtrails.
Yeah, exactly.
Chemtrails.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's all about the chemtrails, mm-hmm. I guess.
Always.
I have a question from Neku Sakuraba, who asks, how do you guys feel about reviewing MMOs? Like, do you think it's worth it, or is there so much time and effort that's put into them to really understand the game mechanics that, like, is it worth reviewing them?
I don't know. It's a weird situation because, you know, in in a lot of cases, you know, we live in a culture now where games are getting patched at a rapid rate, even if they're not MMOs, but MMOs especially change so rapidly that the review you write at launch is going to be pretty obsolete, like 3 months down the line, sure. 6 months, something like that. So, you know, the traditional review model doesn't necessarily work. So I think the best approach, but at the same time, there are people that want to know at a game's launch or around a game's launch, should I play this game at all?
And, is it worth $60?
Is it worth that initial price? Mm-hmm. But then from there, like, you know, the right way to cover an MMO is probably to stick with it and have regular updates about here are the changes they made and here's how they impact your character. And then at some point, as part of that process, you can extrapolate and say, like, this game is now worth buying where it wasn't worth buying before, or hey, they broke all this stuff and now it's no longer worth buying again, or something like that. But yeah, it's a hard problem to deal with because you kind of need infinite resources to have, you know, at least one person per game or something like that. So generally speaking, it's not necessarily all that worthwhile.
It seems like even single player games are starting to fall prey to that same thing, though.
Where like Skyrim.
With the rapid patching, you know. Skyrim, I think, has had, what, one patch so far? Almost
there. Three. The third one, I think, just hit. Yeah.
One was a little one, and then there was a one that broke everything, and then now they put the one that fixed all the stuff that they broke out.
Yeah, I installed the one that broke everything.
Yeah, that was bad.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
PS3 still doesn't have the one that fixes it.
Yeah, they fixed the stuff that they had to break and fix on other platforms, mm-hmm. but at least the PS3 specific stuff is still jacked.
At least he said the crash was incoming.
Well, we kind of knew because like I wasn't able to spawn my my little ground vehicle I was trying to get on there. So, Star Wars Galaxy's servers not proving to be super stable right now. So we're gonna hang out here, and then I'm gonna try and get back in. We'll keep taking questions from you in the chat. If you want to give us a call, 415-508-3975 is the number. And we'll chat with you. I don't know. I guess I'll start patching Star Trek Online.
Sure. That game still works, right?
Star Wars, Star Trek, it's all the same, right?
No, one's clearly better than the other.
Which one, though?
One's still running.
Star Trek is better.
Okay. I've never actually seen this game.
I'm not even talking about the games.
Oh. I don't care enough about it to argue. I think the Enterprise could probably take apart a Star Destroyer.
Yeah, probably.
But I think that a lightsaber probably beats a phaser. So all in all, it's a wash.
Yeah, you might be right.
Yeah.
What about the Type 2 phaser, the rifles?
Six to one. Yeah. I mean, if you can block the phaser, it's just lightsaber always wins.
Yeah.
It's the Chuck Norris of laser swords.
They're supposed to be able to do that with while blindfolded. So.
Yeah, I mean, deaden my senses and blast shields and.
Right.
Man, I got some jittery legs today. I don't know what's going on, man.
Too much caffeine, man.
Got the Jimmy legs.
Probably cut back.
I didn't remember wearing shorts today. I thought I was wearing long pants, but I mean, I guess maybe not.
Maybe they're cutoffs.
Who can say?
Seems unlikely.
Jesus.
Oh, my God. There's an extra leg. Matthew Rory, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, yeah. That's.
Speaking as a viewer, it's terrible.
Wild has a question. Do you think that the next generation of consoles will support MMOs, or is that? Do you think that's just going to remain a PC exclusive thing?
They already do have MMOs. Can you hear me, Kenny? I'm just going to talk to you guys and look.
Yeah, they already do have MMOs. You're right.
But that Rory says there are already MMOs.
More of them besides like Final Fantasy XI and stuff.
I think that's one of those things that, you know, the genre is going to continue to change, and
it's like assuming that they would never be a first person shooter on a console.
Right.
They'll fucking figure it out.
Yeah, they'll figure out something. It might not resemble the MMOs that you see on PC right now, but they'll certainly have something that'll be subscription based or free to play games that are built with microtransactions in mind and stuff like that. That's the sort of stuff that has risen over the course of this generation in different ways. So I would expect a lot of that to be better handled next time around.
Well, do you think they'll have problems like with EA did with Steam about DLC stuff where they want to have their direct line in? Like, I know basically now you have to buy Xbox points or whatever, and it goes through Microsoft. Do you think EA will have fits they want to have their own credit cards going directly to them, or what?
I think that when you're dealing with a closed system like a console, I think the expectation that you're going to have to cut the hardware manufacturer in mm-hmm. is a lot deeper than on the PC, you know, because EA can build its alternative, they can go out and build Origin. They can't go out. Well, they can't. They're not going to go out and build their own console. No. So I think they'll be a little more likely to play ball and let Microsoft and Sony and Nintendo theoretically.
Or they'll monetize it with the microtrans like other. They'll find other ways to make money off.
Yeah.
That don't involve Microsoft points.
Right. But they've already got subscription services up and running on some of that stuff. You know, you get PlayStation Plus on the PS3. You can subscribe to Call of Duty Elite or Phantasy
Season
Star
Pass
Universe.
Or whatever, yeah.
And, yeah, mm-hmm. Season Pass type stuff. But they've got auto-renewal systems already built in for both platforms. So it's just a matter of...
Again, my problem is not keyboard right. for that shit.
I think the games that would come out that you would call an MMO on a console will have to look completely different. And have totally different expectations and everything.
I mean, people talk about WoW on consoles, but like WoW is when you're in a boss fight or whatever, you need to really be clear. Like you need guys. And I guess you can do a voice chat to a certain degree, but when you're talking about big scale MMOs, it's really tough.
Right. You need to you would need a smaller player group to have voice chat work at all, and have it actually be effective and all that
some
stuff.
Some sort of hierarchy that no one will ever follow. And
right. Yeah, you need to have like a leader who could override everybody else.
That was
but
something
it's,
that,
but it's
that
just systems.
They had communication channels. It was 128 players, so you'd have you'd have one leader who would talk to four dudes, who would talk to eight dudes, who would talk to the individual squads. And they built that kind of order system in.
It's like Chinese telephone.
Yeah, a little bit.
But they did. I mean, they did that with PlanetSide with chat, where like the people who had the high command rank could have the global chat.
Yeah.
But all anybody ever used it for was, you know, jokes and fucking around.
Or no one would ever listen to it. There'd be like the high rank guy, like, you need to get over here right now, and it would be like, whatever.
Dude, I'm in my Reaper. I'm
fine over here to hack this tower. Yeah. Like, leave me alone. I don't want to be part of your weird thing.
But it's a solution that just needs a system. It's not like it's a technological issue. Like, even with the current, hardware problem, the current hardware stuff that's in place, you could pull off an MMO. You would just need to figure out the right systems to make it work.
And the other question is, like, what's the book? Phantom Zone, Ryan.
Don't set off a bomb in space or Ryan will escape. it's like Drive Time PM radio commercials or something like that.
Yeah.
But with
Drive
video.
Time PM radio.
Yeah.
PM radio. I don't hear that phrase too much.
But I mean, the other question is, what's the part about MMO that people like? Is it the persistence? Is it the whole boatloads of people in the game?
See, I was always a really weird MMO player. Like, I played WoW almost solo the entire time. I hated being in groups.
I did a lot of that, too.
Yeah. So it's oh, my God.
It's about being self-reliant.
Definitely.
Being your own man.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Exactly.
You versus the world.
Totally.
Yep. But you can do stuff
but
like
Diablo. But then they decided they wanted to charge me a monthly fee. To play a game that was maybe not as good as other single-player games out there. And then it became this moment of, like, I don't need a chat room attached to the games I play.
Although it is fun to have a guild and have, like, guild chat open while you're out doing stupid shit. I like Eraserhead.
But there's IRC still. So you can you can
there
do that at other
venues. Oh, my God.
I get multiple
monitors. What's the movie with the big-headed guys? The MST3K movie that they did?
This Island Earth?
This Island Earth? Yeah. You totally look like... That dude.
He kind of looks like the Beneath the Planet of the Apes guys too.
But the big problem I ran into with World of Warcraft was that I was not going to play as much as the people I was playing with, and it got to a point where they had leveled so far that they didn't want to come back and help my ass. So and I didn't want to team up with strangers, so I was kind of assed out.
Well, and even games that have that mechanism to help with that, like the sidekick thing that's in City of Heroes, still. Like, it still was kind of broke. Like, it worked, but it wasn't fun on a long-term basis. It was only good for, like, I'm behind for, like, 3 days. I'm going to play with them in a limited capacity, and then I'll spend 2 weeks leveling up real hard so I can be, like, a normal first-class citizen again.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How's that going over there?
I'm downloading Star Trek Online. I mean, tag you in here, Jeff, because Star Wars Galaxies doesn't kind of seems like it's not coming back.
It has to come back, though.
Honestly,
it has to come back!
It doesn't. They could just say,
we were promised 99 more minutes.
If the servers went down, would you, if you're the server admin for
would you Star be Wars Galaxies to get them point, back up?
No. Fuck Star Wars Galaxies, go bowling.
They're probably all drunk at this point anyway.
Yeah, they got an hour and 40 minutes to go. Don't you want to
dear Lord.
Don't you want to give people that final bit of glory? You told them 9 o'clock. Don't you want to, you know, you want to try to give them?
I mean, you're right. Yeah, they ought to do that.
They're working on the servers with a hatchet right now.
That's a lot of Ks per second there.
Weird. Yeah, no, Star Trek is downloading very quickly.
You still like PlanetSide, too. Do you have a PlanetSide account that still works?
I have a PlanetSide account that still works.
We should play PlanetSide. Fuck it.
Here, check this out.
Is it installed?
Oh, wait, hold on. It's the Galaxy's loading again.
Oh. Do you remember our...
The next time it crashes, I'm totally loading up PlanetSide because I've got it on this.
Fuck yeah.
Would be 5K, would be 5 gigs, 5 megs a second would be... Yeah. I was reminiscing about our old internet connection at the
I
Salt
remember
office.
Back in the day.
Oh, that was some bad
back
internet.
In the year ago.
Yeah.
We were all sharing a
2400 baud modem.
Yeah.
It was DSL.
Yeah.
It was DSL.
It was a DSL connection.
Yeah.
Two of them dual bonded or something or was it even
it was, yeah, it was like a 10 down and 1 up or something like that.
Uploading videos real fun on that connection.
Yeah, that was bad.
The thing about that was that you would upload videos and the internet and the rest of the office would stop working.
Yes.
Or we were always uploading videos.
Yeah, we always had to check the people. Who's using the internet?
Download porn over here.
It's like, who's on? Mom, get off the phone! And upload a video.
Yeah. And Brad on BitTorrent or...
Holy mackerel. Yeah. Some of these server imbalances always are pretty crazy. Like,
Rebel Forces pretty heavily overrepresented.
But there's one server at the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Sunrunner, 4% Rebel Forces, 96% Imperial.
Imperial. Wow.
It's probably like...
Hopefully this will load.
Hey, are these all the servers that are left?
I believe so.
I like how there's one server just called SWG. Like that, hey... If you're gonna that's like having a World of Warcraft server called World of Warcraft. Which one are you gonna pick?
That's it. That's the World of Warcraft. All these other ones are bullshit. I don't want to play Actually, I do want to play Bloodfin. That would be a pretty good game.
Shadowfire. Some crazy. Oh, there you go. We're in. Hey, where's this play?
Congratulations.
Do I have my? I didn't put my glasses on to see this right. Right. It's kind of blurry because I don't have my glasses on.
Yeah. Put your 3D glasses on now. Child's bed.
Yeah. Cybernetic on. Oh, these are quests? Oh, these are your... Are they just giving you everything?
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, pretty much.
Oh, you get a painting, dude.
Like all Luke their Skywalker someplace. Awards. Is it really Mark Hamill operating Luke Skywalker? That seems like...
That would be kind of awesome.
Yeah.
Wait, Circus Horrificus Auto Beast Feeder. That sounds like the
awesome, though.
Most
awesome,
metal band ever.
Yeah.
Circus Horrificus. Oh no!
Look at what you've done.
Oh, okay.
Wow. All tab.
This is even funny because I can't see our intimate moment down here.
I know. You guys are just touching each other for nothing.
Structural deeds. There's just all sorts of crazy shit in here. Hold on, ATPT Walker.
You know, nobody on the internet can see what you're doing because Andy and Jeff and Rory and I are over top of the window that you're gazing so intently at.
Gazing?
You're gazing.
I'm sorry, did you say something wrong?
Beautiful vistas of Tatooine.
What? Is this Tatooine again? I didn't think there was surface water on Tatooine.
Tatooine, it's not Arrakis, dude. It's
I don't believe we're on Tatooine. Go to Alderaan.
See? I told you. Alderaan's blown up. It's an asteroid rubble field.
Yeah, we're here on the capital planet here.
This is Coruscant?
Coronet, thank you very much.
Let's see here. Let's planet map. No.
Downloading data.
The planet map looks like a 2D map.
It's pretty cool.
Oh. You should file a bunch of support requests. Guys, I'm giant.
We're on Corellia. The
game's broken.
Which is basically the center here. We go to Kashyyyk, which is where all the...
Wookiees are.
Filthy Wookiees are.
I don't think you can go there. Did you just sneeze?
Yeah.
For some reason, if you say Kashyyyk, I think of a Cheech and Chong. Like, I don't know why, that's my instant, like, mental...
Kashyyyk?
Cheech and Chong. Like, I just imagine a bunch of Wookiees and lowriders getting high.
That'd be a...
I would watch that
movie. Cheech Chong, Wookiees.
Cheech Chong and Chewbacca?
Yeah.
You know, there's only one dude who's allowed to play Chewbacca? Like, one actor who can... The only,
Peter
Mayhew. I'm talking about the guy who goes to conventions and shit. There's only one dude who's allowed to be a Wookiee for Star Wars stuff.
Like, they have an official Wookiee actor.
They have one official Wookiee actor. I'm sure he's, like, some 7 foot tall dude. Oh, my God.
Probably pretty in demand.
Is that your ATPT dude?
Yep.
Can you get in that thing? Or?
I remember these from Rogue Squadron.
Rogue Squadron.
I would love to be a
rogue
squadron.
Can you shoot tow cables?
Wedge is really dreamy.
Stuff.
Look how fast you're chicken walking.
Yeah! Oh, this is running terribly.
You turned the graphics up and you introduced lag to Star Wars Galaxies.
That was a weird shadow there.
Wow. That's fine. Don't worry about it. That's
no big deal.
This planet, weird sun.
I remember at one point, I don't want to say who or at what company they worked, but somebody who developed MMOs told me that 3D rendering with dedicated graphics cards was a real fad, and that we're going to be doing all the graphics rendering on CPUs by 2005.
Yep, and it happened.
Well, isn't that what Intel's working on?
They've been working on it since 2002.
Yeah. But eventually it makes sense. Like, eventually a CPU will be so, at some point in the future, they'll be so powerful that you won't need.
Maybe.
You
won't need it, but if you had it, think about how much better things could look.
I'm saying eventually CPUs will be above and beyond. Like, give it 15 years, and eventually we will be able to render pixel stuff in real time.
It's different tasks. It's a lot of really
is
simple
that Michael
math
Jackson?
Run massively parallel versus a lot of complex math run serially. So there's a place for both. Wow, that
kind
of
talk to me over fancy words.
I'm just using words, man.
Wow, words. Somebody's chasing a Jedi. What? Don't kill her. What are you doing? She's just running.
Run faster with sparks.
Oh my god.
I don't have sparks.
Fireworks coming out of her butt.
Well, she has sparks. Why don't you have sparks?
You got plus zero health.
She has pretty cool hair.
And that's why I started chasing her.
Also, she's the only girl here.
Yeah, that's also why he's chasing her.
So these are NPC
Find the robots for her. Totally white knight for that female.
But those are stormtroopers, dude. They're not robots.
They're NPC guards, I think. So.
You know, if you're going to blow your faction, this is the time to do it.
Tell me more about faction blowing.
Tell me more about blowing.
If you're an Imperial, you would shoot stormtroopers. If you're a rebel, you would shoot Luke Skywalker.
Well.
Oh my god, X-Wing.
That's an old Republic fighter.
That's
a dumb one from an old Republic movie.
Dumb one.
Prequel dumb fighter.
What the hell is that thing?
That was what I believe Anakin was in when he blew up the Rebel command ship.
In the first one?
Your first one.
Everything was so shiny in those prequels.
I barely remember anything about them.
That's, oh my god!
I don't think best I saw policy. The third one.
That is a big.
The third one was the best of them.
Mm-hmm. I like the second one.
But it's a real. The second one was okay.
I like all the political stuff. And the weird thing is, someone was making the joke, like, it's on Twitter today.
People make jokes on
Twitter. I would dislike SOPA and the other one a lot less if George Lucas had warned us about that in episode one.
Well, apparently groups have stopped working.
Okay.
Good.
Who needs them?
Solo Not game, Star Wars no. Galaxies That's for too right. much damn longer.
This is the final 90 minutes, everyone dies alone.
Socially awkward penguin. His favorite game ever right now.
I wonder if you can call up and get a refund right now for the last 90 minutes.
It's like, hey, this is not the game I paid for.
That's right.
I only count credit for the last hour. Okay, you get five nickels. Oh my god, it's crap! Oh!
Oh wow,
it's Star Wars 9/11 over here. Oh, Lord.
Too soon, dude.
The effect of the item has been activated.
Is this your pet? How long did it take you to learn how to play this game, Ryan?
I think I put about 5 or 6 hours into this.
That's not too bad.
Harry, how many people are in chat yet? Still.
2,794 are chatting, 5,673 are watching.
Wow. Still probably strong. About 100 times as many people probably should be watching.
So if those people that are just watching want to hang out in the chat so they can ask Perry questions, they should just go to giantbomb.com/chat.
That's right. And giantbomb.com/chat.
Send where two questions.
Yeah.
Let's yeah.
At questions. Like at Twitter.
Oh my god.
Yep. Right.
This shit is so exciting. I can't
take
believe
some
it.
Questions.
What I wish there was a womp rat.
Is that a house?
I wish there was something ship? That you could not do. Oh, you're inside your ship.
Cave Mantum.
Why?
Wants to know, has instancing improved or diminished the quality of nature of MMORPGs?
That's a serious question.
Necessary yeah. thing to have.
It solves some problems, but then reduces the feeling of scope.
There's no lower guck anymore. Do you remember Lower Guck?
Oh,
the awesome trains that. You could make in Lower Guck just by shooting the wrong dude?
I think it's necessary to have any kind of high-end especially with the architecture they have now, you can't have 100,000 people doing the same dungeon without some kind of instance.
I think we need to bring back the thing where everyone is waiting in line for mobs to spawn.
Yeah.
That was the old EverQuest stuff. That's a really good idea, actually.
Yeah. That was the opposite of fun.
No. WoW had some of that with world bosses that you would know it's going to spawn in a bit. And you'd get a text from
your raid leader who's like, Auxia has spawned, you got to haul ass.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then you drive recklessly to get home.
I mean, you can't have that be the entire game, but you can. That is actually a really good alternate to instant. You can have a few of those, like the dragons, and there were world dragons in WoW for a long time that were just kind of like first person sees it, you tag it and you wait for your guild to show up and try not to die.
And there were server rules, mm-hmm. like some servers had first come first serve and something like yeah.
Well, there was griefing too. There was a good one in WoW that every time this world boss killed somebody, he would gain like 25% of his health back. So when an alliance guild would tag the boss and start engaging him, he'd have a bunch of horde people running up.
Yeah.
And like, kill me! Okay, cool. Yeah. And the boss would just keep on getting all his health back. Mm-hmm. Fun stuff.
But I mean, that griefing stuff was some of what made EverQuest. Even as a victim of the griefing more often than not,
right.
That's what made EverQuest kind of fun and weird and neat.
Well,
it's gone from a lot of modern MMOs.
Again, it's something that is in WoW. They don't have many of those things now, but it is something that's pretty fun to do as an alternative to the more structured, everybody just sign up and hit a button, you warp to the dungeon kind of stuff.
Well, and the whole shared dungeon experience, like somebody would train a dungeon and you'd wipe everybody in there, and then 20 people work together to fight your way back to each individual camp naked. That was fun. Breaking into Plane of Hate was a hell of a fun raid, mm-hmm. even though you failed almost every time you did it, like 3 or 4 times.
Yep.
Oh, almost every time you did it? 3 or 4 times? That's really?
No, I'm saying it took 3 or 4 times to establish a beachhead into the raid zone. It was weird.
That's what he's saying.
Yeah, man.
DCUO had a lot of world bosses, but I think they got to a point where as long as you were doing a significant percentage of damage to it, you would get credit for it. So you'd see like Bizarro Superman just walking around, hanging out, and someone would be like, let's fight the guy, and then he would, you know, get all up in everyone's face and start wasting fools.
Well, some of those wild world bosses, you could get in a position that they just, like, nobody would have enough damage to own the kill, right?
No, you never do it without a guild, you tag it and it'd be locked to your side. The really fun thing with the world bosses was training them back to capital cities, because there was one big dude that he would just have this multiple death bolt that would hit everything and people would train him back to Stormwind and just start killing everybody. And at one time they had to restart a server just to get rid of him, because he just fucking just started killing. Who's that dude? Is that your major domo?
What?
Is that your major domo?
This is not my ship.
Oh, you're on somebody else's
ship? I got invited onto someone else's ship.
You're ship jacking.
No, they invited me on. It's the only way you can be on someone else's ship is if they invite you, but I don't have permission, so I can't sit in the operations or pilot's chairs.
Is he gonna try and touch you in a private place? Is that
what you come in my ship?
You're real short.
That's what she said.
I'm a little short. I'm a Rodian.
Are you a little Rodian?
Little Rodian.
I don't know what the average size
battle stations
of a Rodian is.
Greedo is the average size for a Rodian.
Little Thanks. Rodian would be a good rap name.
Yes.
Is that?
Yep.
Get on the bed.
Yeah, that's what he wants.
This is fascinating.
Oh my God! Oh Lord, that is super intimate. When you're inhabiting the same space, that is when you become...
That's a ghost Wookiee.
To become one.
It's like that Spice Girls song.
Yeah. Ghost Wookiee.
Or the Rilkie poem.
Who?
Oh, everybody's got the same bed. Yeah. Woo-hoo. Oh, here we go. Wookiee's coming to sit down.
Inside dudes. Inside ghost Wookiees.
Let the Wookiee in.
Hot. This is how you cyber in galaxies.
What's that thing down there on the floor beside you? Is that?
That's a used condom, but don't tell anybody. Yeah. Oh my God! Look at that! Wow.
Oh my God! The Imperials are here.
Do it. Try and do a slash dance on the. Oh my God!
I need this.
I'm into this. I think I'm pregnant now. Dude, Baka says. Here we go. Oh. All right.
Wow. We're one re-ease away from a...
Well, 8 becomes 1.
Now everyone hit your fusion button and become one dude.
Do we need to show the M logo?
Yeah,
the
just
ESRB?
Blur this out. Don't show this to the kids.
I hope somebody's taking screenshots of this.
Too kinky.
There are rules against this on Justin.
I think there's a voodoo doll right by the bed, too.
Oh my god, what the hell happened?
Oh lord.
Oh, is he playing? Are you inside a Millennium Falcon type thing, or is
else? Something like that.
Hey, your group's working again. That's exciting.
Wow. Have sex with the
friendly robot.
Droid robot. R2-P1. He wants to...
P1.
He wants to be peed on.
It's that kind of spaceship, huh?
How you doing, Ryan?
Guys, I'm kind of understanding why they're shutting down Star Wars Galaxies.
Yeah?
What do you think the core reason is?
It's kind of boring.
Hey, can you get into that turret with the ladder
no.
and shoot? Oh, man. I wish you could shoot something.
It's a lot of things like that of, hey, can you do this awesome thing?
No.
That was 8 years ago. It was before they had figured out...
Awesome. But this game was not built 8 years ago. The game that we're playing does not resemble at all the 8-year-old game.
Sure.
Well, there's still Wookiees.
I'm sure a lot of people worked very hard and did what they could to...
Oh, dear!
...do something.
Oh, look what you've done now.
Explosion.
Jesus Christ.
Somebody set off the fireworks on the ground. Look who doesn't have a thumb now.
You were not the owner of that.
Can you kill the dude that owns the ship and, like, take his ship? Because that'd be kind of fun.
How do I get off the ship? The world's spinning. How do I get off?
He's got space dementia.
Ah, I get it. Perry, any questions from the chat?
Yeah. Lay them on me.
Yeah.
Or him. Whatever.
Yourself. Galoy wants to know, how big and crazy do you think the party for the end of WoW will be?
In probably 10 years, assume it'd be, I would log back on for the end of WoW.
I would reactivate my account for the end of WoW.
I would pay my 10 bucks for the month and
I don't know, at the end of the day though, they're not gonna shut it down when it's still profitable, right? So.
That's what I'm saying, it'll be 10
years. It'll be a while.
It'll be a long time. That'll probably be the oldest MMO in the world.
Do you guys ever fire up old MMOs? I mean, I know you guys never got like, deep into MMOs or not necessarily, but do you ever fire up old? Inactive MMOs and check out, see what's going on.
No.
Yes.
I'm a little while ago. I re-downloaded Anarchy Online to try it out.
Mm-hmm. That's still a thing.
Yeah, yeah. It went free to play at some point. So they changed up some of the rules about how it works. But I have an account that does not expire, so thought I'm gonna get back in here and play some Anarchy Online. Couldn't actually get it to load.
Okay.
Planet Side. This is like right after Windows 7 came out, so it was maybe. Yep. Compatibility was a little weird back then. Couldn't get that working. Couldn't get PlanetSide working. It was a sad day.
So your nostalgia trip for MMOs just was a complete debacle.
Yeah. You know, I think PlanetSide might have had the biggest gap between promo screenshots and actual way the game looked for most people. You remember those first screenshots of that game came out? Yeah.
Yeah.
Here's a 2200 pixel promo screenshot. That's and then you actually load up
like,
the game and it
looked like Tribes 3. It looked with 300 people on
beautiful.
It.
Beautiful. Right, yeah. But the actual game.
Which would have been awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Planet Side was great right up until they released that expansion. When they added mech suits and weird tunnels, it kind of. I thought that stuff was.
It was the
really
core or whatever.
Yeah, the core stuff was weird.
Didn't like
great
that
idea,
stuff
though. Great idea.
Well, they had mech suits before, but they were like one man mech suits. It wasn't like a giant Voltron thing.
Yeah.
The whole idea of.
And they took the map and broke it up. They had a cataclysm. Took all their,
it was more
their
of a
territories. Yeah,
though,
they could tackleize pretty hard.
But the idea of a MMO FPS is a grand one. That is a great idea. The problem is you can't kill people too quick, or it becomes really laborious. You have to make sure there's a penalty to dying, but without making it. What was it?
Well, you can't make a Twitch MMO because of the stuff like the collision and all the physics stuff happening down on the server. That's the
Frontline. What was the game I'm thinking of? The big, like, 128 player server FPS. Was that?
Mag on the PlayStation 3.
No. I'm thinking of a PC game that.
You're thinking
that had
about the thing from the Desert Combat guys, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Point or whatever.
And it was one of those, like, 128 player per side, not an MMO, but it was a very large servers. And every time you died, you'd spawn way back. Way back. So it was kind of like Arma, but different.
Well, even in like enemy territory in those kind of games, death was a powerful motivator to not, like the penalty for having to run back or get in a vehicle or whatever and drive back for 10 minutes, pretty powerful motivator to not die.
Mm-hmm. That's a pretty powerful motivator to not play.
Yeah. That's what turns out,
yeah.
So people like Call of Duty, man, you die and you're right back in it.
Like, I kind of don't mind dying in shooters. Or I like to play shooters where I don't have to mind if I occasionally die. It's like, yeah, whatever, I got shot in the head. I shot more guys in the head that shot me in the head, so I feel good about it.
Yeah.
Like, whatever.
It's
like,
all about a KD ratio.
Kind of, yeah. Yeah. I'm not about these high stakes.
We've got a booze cruise going here.
Oh, very nice.
I've got this full boat of dudes.
Scream some of the haters. Got a nice ring to it. Every superhero needs a
real sausage fest on your boat there, buddy.
Yeah, where'd that Lady Jedi go?
Well, it is an MMO.
Yeah.
Oh. I don't know.
It's on there.
Yeah, when once you started playing Planet Side and realized that that aiming didn't really matter very much,
yeah,
that was a little bit of a letdown.
Right.
But then they rolled out a bomber, so you kind of didn't care that much.
Yeah, the vehicle stuff in that game was pretty fun. And you could pretty easily respec your stuff. So if you wanted clearance for a specific vehicle, you'd be like, okay, I'm just gonna go rebuild my guide so that I can pilot this thing.
Yeah, well, you could do it like once a month or something, right? So you could. You couldn't
might wipe have been
it
more
every day.
Frequently. You couldn't wipe it every day. There was something with it.
I feel like you now you'd have to pay for that.
Frequently.
Now they'd be like $5 and you now can respect all you want.
Well, Planet Side 2 is going to be a free-to-play game, so there's going to be all kinds of weird hooks in it for.
Do you think they'll do like a hey, if you pay us $10 a month, you don't have to you can, because like the thing that I don't like about a lot of the free-to-play stuff is I would if I'm really into the game, I would happily pay $10-$15 a month to bypass a lot of that bullshit.
Right, to not have to make the decisions about do I have to deal with this? And, I tend to agree. I wonder if they'll offer like just a paid. Opt out of the.
I don't know. It's like a lot of the iOS stuff that's either real cheap and then they have microtransactions. Mm. A lot of the times, I would just rather pay $6 and not have to fool with it.
Right. Mm.
And would be happy to do it.
It'd be fine if that was an in-app transaction. You know, let the free version exist as like almost like a demo.
Yeah.
And just say like, hey, we'll nickel and dime you for this stuff if you want it, but look, just. Hit this button and get it over with.
I think that's the way. I think even Planet Side is, and WoW is the same way. You can play a certain number of levels for free,
right?
And then once you reach a certain point, if you want to go beyond that, then you have to.
Warhammer Online is the same deal.
Yeah.
So it's like the whole first tier of that stuff. You can endlessly fight over those territories and all that stuff, but if you want to get to the actual end game.
Yeah.
But that creates the weird problem where I imagine, and I actually logged back into Warhammer Online some point earlier this year, and my character is kind of mid-game, ghost town. I'm sure that the early parts are probably super packed because it's free, and everyone who paid is probably just like at the end game going over the highest tier stuff, but the whole middle of the game just felt like...
Well, that middle ghost town is a problem on
any
level. Like if you're not in the initial wave of people to get, especially when they shut the server off and it reaches a certain population, I mean, that was always, like that's what happened on my WoW server is, I played, everybody else out-leveled me, and then it's like me and four dudes who are there, and it's always the same four dudes, and it's like, oh, man. Oh, back to Stratham.
Maybe they need wave-based deployment, almost like...
Yeah.
You know, almost like enemy territory or something like that, but, like, you can all create characters this day.
Yeah.
Like, this is the day that new characters will become active, so that there'll be some kind of critical mass.
Cycle it in,
theoretically, if you play... an average amount of time, you'll stick somewhere in that group and make your way through.
Jeff Gerstmann solving problems.
Solving problems.
That's what we do here.
What people want is instant gratification. You don't want to like hit the create character button and go like, come back in 9 days. Like, oh, fuck you. I'm gonna go play something else.
On the other hand, like the other end of this free to play microtransaction is like you start playing. You, hey, you know, we could make you level 60 right now for $45.
Right.
And then you're gonna have a bunch of people who are max level that don't know what the hell they're doing.
Yeah. Well, that was the problem with the power level and services and gold farmers and stuff.
Well, even the soloers. Like, if you get to level 60, you have somebody who's soloed their whole way up. They don't know what they're supposed to do. They don't want to manage aggro in a group situation.
Yeah,
they got
total.
They're real.
They're useless. For the end game. For sure.
I think one thing that would be really awesome is if somebody figured out how to dynamically balance dungeons based on the group makeup. Because if I can't find a tank or I can't find a healer, like, maybe I just have five mages in my group and we're just all buddies and, like, we want to go, you know, fuck some shit up. Like,
there should be an all-mage version of a dungeon.
Yeah, and it just, like, it tunes the characteristics of the enemies to that where, like, the mages can, you know, maybe they have to... be creative in how they kill things, but like let them be able to at least accomplish that.
Right. Skyrim, I mean, it's obviously single player, but I think Skyrim does that to a certain extent where as you spec your character in a specific direction, the guys that you'll find at the end of dungeons will automatically be the opposite of what you are to counter how you build your character.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And it's kind of interesting. And that seems like how it is anyway, because I know we were talking about, like, oh, I always face ice guys because I've switched to all melee, so anything that drops my stamina down is going to be a little more devastating.
Okay.
But someone playing a mage is going to find someone who shocks a lot because that drops your...
I did find that. Yeah. Some of those bosses in the Skyrim dungeons are pretty hard.
Yeah, for just being regular dudes. Like, they can get pretty tough. Yeah. But I got to a point where I feel like I've leveled past the difficulty curve a little bit, or spec past it, or whatever it is, because the last 8 or 9 hours I played, just nothing, no problems.
Even after the patch that they released yesterday, the day before? Okay. Yeah, I intentionally, wow, something crazy just happened. I intentionally played that game in a way that trying to prevent that from happening, because Oblivion and Fallout both stopped being fun, because... Like, once you out-level the game, then it's just like, okay.
Well, for me, it's, you know, I beat the Thieves Guild stuff. I have, like, pretty good sneak gear.
Yeah.
And I was using the Thief Stone, so my sneak stat was increasing really quickly.
Yeah.
So I can just hide and backstab anything. Or I didn't actually get backstab, but I can just do the double damage with the mace that I'm rocking and one-shot most things.
Oh, shit. Apparently I can fly my spaceship underwater.
Okay.
Well, I'm just finding out.
Episode one, dude?
Yeah.
Yeah, here, check this out.
Are you on Naboo?
Amphibians.
You're on desert Naboo.
We're not on Naboo.
Where are you at, Boo?
Corelli? Corellis?
Corellia. Yeah.
See, that's water. I'm underwater.
Oh, my God. Seems like it's probably not real good for your spaceship.
Whatever.
Get a little water in the engines.
Fuck,
I worked
spaceship.
In Dagobah. I'm good.
It's too big.
A few users have been curious what your thoughts are on, like, sort of MMOs like Second Life, where it's kind of a game, but at the same time, it's not really, like,
I'm good, thank you.
To you guys.
Well, it's really a chat room.
Yeah, it's an interactive.
Like, have you guys played it a lot, or did
it's
you?
It's a mutt,
like,
really.
I messed around with there a little bit.
Yeah.
And hated it. I had a couple of friends that were into it and actually made a lot of money selling designs in that world.
Yeah. If you had skills.
Yeah, but it was like real basic, like Photoshop skills.
There's two, there's all textures.
My,
like
my friend
skins,
Dave
right?
made a Dune Buggy skin that looked like the General Lee, cleaned up. It's all took.
Nice. Seems about right.
Yeah. And that thing seemed mad stupid. Second Life always just seemed like a horrible joke. And it was one of those things as someone who likes to play games, seeing all these mainstream media outlets falling all over themselves to cover Second Life and say, like, oh, it's amazing, video game worlds, no, it's like, you don't understand what the fuck you're talking about.
Look, we bought property in here, we've set up an office for Time Magazine.
Yeah. And it's covered in dicks now, what's happening? Like,
dicks as far as the eye can see, man.
Yeah, that's the best thing that happened to Second Life, is that all those idiots somehow figured that, like, we're gonna build a real thing, this is the new digital frontier, and then just dicks everywhere. Take it, fuckers. Love that.
So you're saying you're gonna do an end of Second Life? You know, their office is right around the corner from us.
Yeah.
Linden Labs.
I mean, I love Second Life. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. We can go over and see them right now.
No, thanks.
You should have heard the doorbell just ring.
We're talking to you about Derek Smart. It's cool.
That's one. Do not say his name two more times or he will appear. Oh, man.
As long as nobody asks any questions in the chat, so Perry says that we're probably okay.
Yeah. Do you ever mess around with any of that stuff? It's just such a non-game. Like, it just seemed like creepy sex people.
Yeah.
There's
a
lot of that.
Yeah.
I did a little bit of data analysis for Second Life.
Really?
Yeah. Kind of just, you know, on the side, as well as at CNET, actually.
Mm.
And they were down on 2nd Street.
Yeah.
And one of my friends from Ubisoft who had left with me knew somebody there, and they're like, hey, we need you to build this data thing. We need to figure out, like, who's buying shit.
Yeah.
And so,
seems like a good thing to know.
They literally gave me a full dump of their database with everything in it.
Yeah.
And my little server at home choked on it for a while, and eventually I figured out that there were people paying tens of thousands of dollars.
Yeah.
Well, they were laundering money for it, right?
It was unclear, actually. Okay. There were definitely a ton of, like,
think Ryan's about to die.
Yeah, he's fighting.
Is this the first fight we've seen so far?
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah.
He's clicking a lot. Do you have to click that much?
It makes you fight harder.
No.
Look, he got healed.
Yeah.
Oh my god, he won. So
you incapacitated Pasquale.
Found out they're money laundering in Second Life, basically.
Well, it was unclear whether they were money laundering or not, but like, it was really interesting to see, like,
wow, he's really dead.
And it didn't seem to be business money; it was like personal money. So it was just really interesting to see, like, people that were actually
garbage collection fees and stuff like that.
No, they were selling property and land.
Oh.
So there's like, as a player, you could buy land from Linden,
mm-hmm.
right? They sold it, and then you could build shit on it, mm-hmm. and you could also create objects in the world. And there was like some very simple scripting system and art asset system that you could like upload.
Okay.
Right?
That's how the Dix came in place.
Exactly, yeah. And then you could sell that. You could sell the patterns like in there. Or you could create the objects and sell them.
Okay.
And people were making real money doing this.
Yeah. There, I believe, has since gone under.
Yes, yeah. They have.
And then there's, what is it? Is it Project Utopia or something? Is another one of those, like,
I've heard about that.
Land things?
I don't know.
There's some
about
creepy
it.
Stories came out of that about, you know, someone's fiance passed away, but the guy's logging in and playing her character, and, like, weird, like, what does it mean? Like, what are the ramifications socially for others? It's like a lot of real.
We went through all those when people were getting married and eligible online and all that stuff too, though, right?
Yeah.
And it's weird stuff. I think
that stuff because it's not. They're kind of not games. There's like maybe some gamey things in there, but they're just kind of crappy chat rooms.
It's from taking Snow Crash too seriously.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's what we were talking about earlier. Dave wants to make Snow Crash, but like in a.
You should go work at Linden Labs.
Yeah.
It's full of dicks.
Around the
corner. Be here all week. Yeah. Try prime rib. Tip your Wookiee.
I go for prime rib.
Yeah. I haven't been to House of Prime Rib in a long time.
Yeah.
I was thinking about it. I think there's a thing.
Yeah, things coming up.
It's
real close
to CES.
I think it's right before.
Okay. Yeah. He wouldn't schedule it while everybody's at CES, I don't think so.
You're about to say he wouldn't schedule it while you were at CES.
Well, I mean, by
CES,
entire
I
industry.
Right.
Because I've never been to that thing.
Neither have I.
Yeah. Well, we should go. I'd go for some House of Prime Rib.
Yeah. Ryan went once.
To what now?
House Prime Rib thing.
Yeah, I've been to the super secret House Prime Rib thing.
Yeah. I like that it's
I was invited to the next one. I probably won't make it.
I was thinking about going. I'm going to be out that week. I'm taking the first week of January.
I like House of Prime Rib, and I haven't had Prime Rib in a long time. And it's conveniently timed for me to enjoy Prime Rib at a time when I think Prime Rib might sound pretty good.
Yeah.
And they have that spinach stuff there, too, which is pretty good.
Mm. You're not going to make the New Year's resolution the common, like, oh, I'm going to go to the gym, I'm going to lose weight, or I'm going to...
No.
Get the wrong with prime rib. It's prime, man. It's prime.
No, dude.
Prime?
I watch. I pay attention to what I eat, prime? So I can eat a shitload of prime rib and stuff like that when I want to.
That's why I eat one meal a day.
That's not really healthy at all.
Yeah, you're right.
You shouldn't do that. You should eat three or maybe four.
For dinner last night, I had frozen yogurt because it was next to the haircut place.
Nice.
Okay, that's okay. Frozen yogurt has two food groups, sugar and
fat.
I
had granola in it. It was low fat, so just sugar.
Yeah. That's good.
Or whatever they replace the sugar with. Aspartame and granola.
Yeah. They look like you're on an Imperial ship now.
No, I'm back on Tatooine.
Was that an alien stormtrooper?
Where?
Left. No, that's right. Keep there. There you go. Oh. Wow. Well, we can't see that because the thing.
Away.
Oh. It isn't.
He's more of a robot man.
Oh, okay.
Guy in stormtrooper armor.
It's a robot wearing stormtrooper armor.
Thomas Hyde wants to know, what's your guy's favorite Star Wars game?
TIE Fighter.
Oh, yeah, here we go.
That's MMO. You should turn the graphics down, dude. We're on a 50 megabit connection, and the game is still lagging.
Yeah, it's pretty sad, right?
I mean, yeah, this, the engine probably can't. Wasn't made to hold this many people. And
it's the end of the world, man.
Yeah.
All, everything's off.
When the world ends, you will see real life lag.
When the world, so you're saying the aliens come down, everybody walks outside, we're all looking around,
and they
flood
our connection, and the frame rate goes to shit.
It's all the
volumetric shadowing and self-shadowing stuff that is killing it. Like, I turn that stuff off, and it peps right back up.
Self-shadowing is always really hard.
Yeah.
What's the
And it doesn't really do it great either.
There's some purple-haired lady in her underwear.
Great.
This was Skyrim.
Do you have any idea how many people are still actually paying for this?
No. No idea.
Sony said that, like, the last few months would be free, like, between September and December.
Mm. But, like, if you had the active account.
If you had the active
September,
account.
They would let you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
What do you think is the minimum? I guess it depends on how much overhead and stuff they have going into it. What do you think is the minimum sustainable audience for, like, an MMO, like, a big scale? You know, like a Tale in the Desert type thing, but something like a big AAA MMO.
I don't really know. I know that, like, the kind of a lot of the stuff that happened post WoW up until this point,
it's like hundreds of thousands of people.
Tens,
for Age of Conan and
some of the
stuff
that's like hanging on, but not necessarily pulling it out. I don't know if that's really profitable or not, but I think a lot of it also depends on where they are in the life cycle. Of the game, because if they're at the point where they already own all their own hardware, then all they're paying for is like electricity and colo, internet, you know.
Yeah, so they start out by like they go down to the rent to own and they pick up the servers there.
Well, I mean,
Hulk Hogan says, you know, go down to the rent a center, brother.
Yeah, rent a center is not good, man. Everybody knows that place is a ripoff.
I think a lot of it depends on the studios, at least. The ones that I've seen, it's based on the studio's anticipation for the game, like how well it's going to do. I'm fairly certain that Blizzard was like, we have a killer here. Let's like just go in and buy a bunch of hardware.
Yeah, they probably have their own data centers at this point, right?
Maybe not. No, they're partnered with AT&T and with one or two other providers.
Are you saying my cell phone signal sucks because they're devoting all their bandwidth to World of Warcraft?
Yes, that's what I hear.
Motherfuckers.
You should just play WoW, man.
For
Can I play it on my phone?
Yeah, why not?
No, I can't because I don't get signal on. For Shadowbane, we leased hardware, and that turned out to be a very good idea.
That was a smart
idea.
Move, yeah.
Yes.
A few people are asking about what your thoughts are on the Dust 514 EVE online plan that they're doing. Do you think it'll work?
I guess I don't really know quite enough about Dust as a game, but I'm really intrigued.
It seems like
it'd
be a real challenge to try and make that relevant to both ends.
It's a first-person shooter that's attached to the EVE intergalactic company,
right? Yeah.
Like making sure that what happens in one is relevant to the other in some way.
I don't know, like it could be like a Dune situation where the one thing that they produce is like starship fuel, something that the rest of the galaxy needs.
Right.
And then there's factions fighting over the resources. And
well, I mean, that's the question, if you have that thing.
Basic idea, but there would be something relatively critical. But I don't know. I hope I think that could be really cool.
I really
like the idea of the EVE universe because all of the... You know, it's just the crazy story about Eve that comes out every 6 months about someone making off with a bunch of real money.
Yeah,
I want to be a part of that, but I refuse to play Eve. It's I'm not. It's way over my head.
Well,
so.
If you ever quit your job, you can just start playing Eve.
Exactly,
it's always there for you.
Eve will be my new job.
Yeah.
That's even too complicated for the unemployed because that's like harder than a real job.
It's like being a day trader.
Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It's like being a day trader for no money.
I deal in spaceship futures.
Yeah, I wish I had some spaceship
Fake spaceship futures.
It's real money, though, Ryan Davis. Look, that is a busted-ass ad over there.
If I can get ISK for shooting dudes in the face, I'm in.
I'm not fast enough to shoot dudes in the face for ISK anymore.
Mm.
Dorky Moore wants to know... Could you guys see MMOs provide their communities with server tools after their life cycle ends, or do you run into like copyright issues
Yeah, no one ever does that because there are. They want to own that stuff in case, what if they decide they want to bring it back someday or something like that, right? I mean,
for the most part, the only exception that I can think about is Uru, the Myst MMO.
Oh, right.
Yeah. They open source their servers.
Yeah.
Well, but part of the problem is that the servers are pretty, it's not like you can just put your old gaming PC in the living room and set up a WoW server. I mean, it's a lot of different servers.
Anymore, yeah, definitely.
My Phantasy Star Online server could run on the same machine I was playing Phantasy Star Online on.
I mean, you could probably run an EverQuest, OG EverQuest server on, at this point. But I remember on EverQuest and WoW, even, like, different areas would go down because different servers would get disconnected or broken or whatever.
Exactly. I think it would be...
That sounds bad.
...fairly complex to set up something... You know, in your house.
Well, I know that they were running private Matrix Online servers. They might still be running them, but it's one of those things where they have emulated the basic protocols.
Have
none of the, or you know, they hadn't implemented any of the mission data or anything like that. So you couldn't play it like a game.
Mm-hmm.
It was just like, hey, you want to go in and chat in the Matrix?
Right. And that's what they did with UO too. I think the difference there is that UO was not nearly as complex from a like there were no quests or anything like
Java's?
That. It was like, yeah, here's the world map.
Mm-hmm.
You get some like level ups for skills and stuff as you use them. It's not that
look
hard
at this. It's pretty much the most interesting place there is.
Look at all those dancing holograms. And the next
seems like there's more people here. We're in the final hour.
Yep, the last hour.
Last hour.
You better not say that. When you said that in the Xbox live stream, it went on for like 6 more hours.
I was out of town, so I never learned that lesson.
That's right.
Hey, look, Darth Vader's dancing.
Darth Vader doesn't
Hell
dance.
Hell yeah, he is.
Giant Darth Vader's rocking out.
I like it when you get close enough for him to pop in.
Who's the purple?
He's playing air sax.
Yep.
Is it the holophoner? Is that one a dancer? This is... How?
Gotta say, Ryan, you're looking a little small.
Yeah, I'm gonna fix that.
Nice job.
Because I agree.
That giant X-Wing pilot.
Bib Fortuna, make me giant!
Now, who's Bib Fortuna?
He's Jabba the Hutt's majordomo. He's the guy that, gets knocked off the back of the podium when Jabba gets pissed off in Return of the Jedi.
Okay.
He's the one
you clearly didn't collect Star Wars action figures.
I didn't, because they were shit.
They were shit, but also they were Star
G.I.
Wars.
G.I. Joes could bend at the elbow.
Bending at the elbow and the knees is for chumps. You had to get Han Solo's legs lined up just right and kind of angle him into the Millennium Falcon, and then maybe you could. Chewbacca never fit, so it was always like Lando or Princess Leia who had to be the co-pilot, and then Chewbacca would just be in the back playing chess,
right?
But not really because his legs were out like this.
Han Solo would call up and talk about the next mission, and he'd be like, "Wait a minute, are you playing chess?" And Chewbacca would be like,
"Yeah, sorry.
What was that?
I'm not doing it again. One time only."
Well, I keep having him resize me. It just makes me smaller.
Small's good.
Such a cruel fate.
I like that. I like that somebody there was wearing the Han Solo spray paint camouflage jacket from Endor.
Mighty Matrix wants to know: do you guys see MMO payment plans changing in the future at all, or you know, do you think that they're going to go more free to play at the beginning, or is that? Or are they going to basically try and keep a subscription plan going and then try free to play if that doesn't pan out?
I think it's, I think some companies might even be calculating to go free to play at some point, but charging subscriptions up front because they spent so much money building the game, they need to make as much of that money back as they can while people are still hot on the game, and then switch to free to play and milk the rest out of everybody that way or
like
something.
Like Guild Wars 2.
Sure, they're not charging a monthly fee for that, though.
Not like that at all.
Okay.
Mesmers.
What's Mesmers?
Mesmerizers. It's the final revealed character class for Guild Wars 2.
It's like an enchanter.
They were in the first game, too.
Okay. Is Dark Age of Camelot still around?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do they still make expansions and stuff for it? Or is
I don't think so, no. They've been doing some updates here and there. Like, it's not a totally dead game.
Asheron's Call went away, but Asheron's Call 2 still around?
Asheron's Call 2 went away.
Oh, but Asheron's Call
1 stuck around.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Turbine.
Yeah.
Wow.
They really screwed the pooch on the second one. It was terrible.
Was that the one where they thought that the players were going to build all the cities and it was crazy?
No, that was Shadowbane.
Oh, right. That was the one you worked on.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice job.
Nice. Yeah. It was pretty awesome when, like, people started attacking cities, and then when the server crashed because of it, that didn't work out too well.
Well, that was a...
Yeah,
that
seems like an issue.
Yeah.
That was a heady time. Like, that was a time when people, like...
It was ambitious.
This MMO thing, this is going to be a big... This is the future of civilization.
And yes. Anything's possible.
Yeah, we could do whatever. Yeah.
Well, yeah. And you have all these publishers being like, look how much fucking money Sony is just rolling in right now. With
Sony Online, not even... Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And
with 300,000 subscribers.
You know that people are very envious right now of Blizzard. I mean, they're making like $1 billion a year.
Yeah.
In revenue on WoW. Right
and WoW is like not at its peak.
Yeah.
You know? WoW is off a little bit.
4 year old, five, no, six. More than that. Six-year-old game at this point?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. And it's doing $1 billion in revenue. It's like, even if we can do a tenth of that,
right.
That's
how we got 20 MMOs in the last 5 years.
You know, five boxed games. Easy.
Right. Yeah. Still, well, big risk.
But the thing the thing that's unfortunate is, like, I love those early days of MMOs because each one was very different.
We go.
Anarchy Online was different, and Shadowbane was different, and Asheron's Call was crazy and different.
Right.
And,
yes.
And now it's all
World of Warcraft,
tank,
like,
healer,
figured out the right way. The Trinity became totally codified.
Well, I mean, that Trinity was in EverQuest, though, too. Yeah. I mean, like, all WoW is easy EverQuest.
Yes.
Made fun.
With like an extreme level of polish.
Yeah.
Like they
good art.
Yes, they nailed it.
Yeah. And instances. Instances made a big improvement in that game, I think.
Yeah.
And actually the exclamation point, so you didn't have to just walk up to every NPC in the game and say press H.
Yeah. Yep.
Like super smart game. Like it deserved its success.
Oh, absolutely.
That game was so good to bring in people that hadn't played MMOs before and thought that those things were for crazy people. Like it was that good. It was that good.
Well, and even the people who were the crazy people playing the other MMOs were like, wow, I didn't realize this could be fun.
Right.
Because at some point you just kept playing EverQuest out of sheer bloody-mindedness.
Yeah.
I remember the first time I booted up EverQuest, and I think I played a human or a elf or something, and I got dropped into Freeport.
Mm-hmm.
And you get dropped in, like, right outside the city, killing rats, right? And you have no idea, like, what you're really supposed to be doing other than killing these rats.
Right, obviously. And, kill
and
rats.
Then you go into this city, and the city is big enough where it's, like, two zones itself.
And there's no signs anything.
And there's no signs. You have
Guys,
no
I'm
idea
giant Darth Vader.
Okay.
Sweet.
Well done.
Never
start,
change.
Start dancing.
Why are you sashaying around like that?
Do you like this little sachet move I've got going?
I love it.
Are you Lady Vader?
Let's get on the dance floor.
You guys like the Scissor Sisters or what? It's very different from Force Unleashed Vader that stomps around slowly murdering everyone in his path. Like
Big Helmet Vader.
Yeah.
That's what Force Unleashed Vader was. Yeah.
Whoa.
Jeez.
Whoa.
Why is that He's Yak Man rubbing him against Vader?
Hold on, can you take Vader's pants off?
No, it's costume.
Oh.
Seriously,
is that his default walk or do you have something weird on?
No, that's his default walk.
Jesus. Less than an hour left of this walk, people. Get used to it.
Was Vader a raid boss or anything? Were there even raids in this?
They had NPCs.
Yeah, they would definitely show up.
Thank you, Dave.
It's okay, Dave. Yeah, I don't know. I like the early crazy MMO days. And then they got kind of silly in WoW. Like all the crazy gnome cars and all that stuff.
They joust in that game at some point.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's funny.
You're flying ostriches and landing them on people.
Was in Cataclysm, I think.
I don't know. I liked the kind of gnome vehicle. Like, I thought Gnomeregan was really cool.
I thought Gnomeregan was a really nice like mid-30s surprise. Yeah. Like you
now they have
like
have like trikes and stuff. So you can get
right,
you can get the trike, and then you can get the sidecar for your buddy.
It's just
too much.
It's too much. Yeah. Point, right? Well, they have like flying, weird flying steampunk stuff now, and it's. It's cool. Whatever. I remember watching that quick look of I guess it was Cataclysm, when the during the beta that Rory and Rory and Ryan.
Yeah.
I don't remember who else.
Rory
and
somebody. Not me.
Yeah, it was Rory and somebody that wasn't you. That is correct.
Yeah.
And I just remember thinking, wow, this is dramatically weird and different from what I remember WoW being.
Right. Mm-hmm. I mean, I stopped playing before the first expansion came out, so it was game is so different now.
Well, I did that, and then I came back for Burning Crusade for a little bit, and then I left again after level 65, whatever.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Matt, Rory.
Do you want to send a drink?
No, I'm good. Thanks.
Hi, Matthew.
Hi.
I'm Darth Vader.
Hi.
Look at me. I'm a really big Darth Vader.
Oh, my God. Is that?
Is what?
Is that?
It's Darth Maul's.
Is that?
I'll see you guys later.
Well, any fine ladies for Sibes is obviously the
right here. Is your fine lady right here?
Culminating moment of Star Wars Galaxies. How you doing, Perry?
I'm pretty good. How are you doing, Rory?
I'm alright.
Holy silver. Stone cold silver.
Flip it on. What you got there?
A little gin on my crotch now.
A little crotch gin. Nice.
Nice.
This part looks really weird. Oh, I should sit on. Oh, there you go. Okay. That's really cool. They can, like. Let me actually sit on your other side because.
No. They already moved the shot.
Oh, okay.
Sweet. So, those that asked, if they wondered, how did Star Wars Galaxies end? It ended with sheer madness.
Thank God. I was worried that might just be a. Limited to the Matrix. I'm glad to see everyone just getting it on.
I love the dance party you got going on
here. What's that hobo with the Yoda backpack? You guys want a hacky sack or what?
It's like Chuck Norris with the Yoda.
Oh, yeah. My God. No! The dead-eyed stare. Oh, my God.
You guys see my didgeridoo?
It looks like an animated Mount Rushmore. Just like 2 feet away from
photobombing ninja behind there. Commando ninja, the dude. And fireworks.
Oh man, the triangle count in this scene is in the three digits. Jabba's going fucking crazy. I'm walking through 10. Fuck you.
I give a shit. I'm Jabba the Hutt. I'm giant fucking Jabba.
Rolling. If this game had had all this.
All of this.
Maybe, you know.
Seriously, somebody asked in the chat before, like, what MMOs, should MMOs have a more kind of laid-back atmosphere? And to a degree, that depends on the server you're on. But I totally think a lot of MMOs could get off, do well with, like, you know, hey, officially, like, Friday night, 8 o'clock, have the GMs come and say, hey, dance party and whatever. We're gonna relax the rules. We're gonna let you guys do what we want to. We'll do something crazy.
Yeah.
Just have every once in a while,
you know, public test realm stuff. Yeah. Of just like.
I mean, WoW's too big for that. They have like what 200 realms to have that kind of, you know, constant attention. But just make them feel like there's something special going on. That fucking Darth Vader.
That's something special right there. What that is.
That is terrible. That's not canon. I don't think. I don't think that's canon.
something more powerful than you can possibly imagine.
This is a violation of the Star Wars license.
My dick's more powerful than you can possibly imagine.
That's expanded universe.
That's what she said. Yeah, just don't even worry about the chat. Let's just get me in a. What's your name again? I've had a few tonight.
Got a few Twitter messages from people saying they also got that same phishing PlayStation Network email.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
So maybe someone is finally doing something with
the database. Yeah.
Just have like a so it had your actual.
It had my PSN username in it.
Hmm. Maybe they didn't get your password.
Sent to my email address. Yeah.
Okay. So. I mean, if you have the email and then a username, you could actually probably get a lot of people by just doing a mass email.
Yeah. So.
Hopscotch is saying. It's not a question, but back in the day, the GMs would show up and host crazy stuff like fights with Vader and all sorts of fun stuff in Star Wars Galaxies.
Do you remember hearing about that? Yeah. I mean, that is the
host invader fights.
That's the weird thing about WoW is, again, the one I mostly know, and WoW is almost too big for that kind of personalized attention. I mean,
right.
When there are 200, 150 servers, you really can't have that kind of stuff coordinated on a regular basis.
Well, and the other thing is just the actual population counts on individual servers is too high.
Yeah, you can't.
Where it's like,
you have to do it for Alliance and Horde if you want to do it, because otherwise people.
They could just set up goofball instances or something where it's just like, hey, form a party, go in here. We've got like three raid bosses in individual rooms across here. Just, you know,
hey, it's not bad. Not a bad idea. Mm-hmm. Is that Rancor doing a dance?
I believe he's trying to.
He has maybe five colors in his texture. I think.
Well, I'm too far away from it. You're not actually seeing all of the correct textures for him. Like, that's the low detail version.
And the low detail animation also. If you get up close,
you're like 20 feet away.
There we go. Yeah, see, it's
it pops in. Yeah. All of a sudden, it's Dark Souls over here. Oh, you're inside him. You can't see him at all.
That's it. I can't.
Lady sitting on her face.
This skeleton's trying to hump me.
Do the Humpty song, Ryan. You know the whole lyrics, don't you?
Let's see here. Taps,
too busy looking at Jabba the Hutt.
Jabba the Hutt's too busy. Oh, look at him.
Jabba the Hutt's rapping, though. He's got his arms all.
Oh.
No one, man, should have. Oh, my God. Halo. Not the game, the actual Halo on somebody's head.
Yeah, it's obviously hard to justify generating new content for a finale like this, but how cool would it have been if they had just, like, as part of the costumes, just like, yeah, we made a Master Chief and made all this other stuff. Yeah. And just like, just Mega Man. And
put the, you know, whatever copyright concerns, don't care about it.
By the time they see it and send us something, we'll all be at work anyway.
The LLC is shutting down. So.
I wonder if anyone working on this is...
No, they should totally have, like, fucking Captain Kirk. Just have
exactly. Like, that's the finale. He just beams down.
The Enterprise comes in. We're going to settle this Enterprise Star Wars shit right now. Yeah. I apologize for getting loud, by the way. I do when I'm in my cups. How's it say? I get loud.
No worries.
What were you going to say, though? Sorry.
I was going to say...
I imagine they have no artists.
Just have no
staff at this point. Yeah, yeah. Like, but I wonder, like, if, like, the staff of this game... If they cover multiple games now, because that's we have so many different games running.
Just taking all the old Matrix assets from Neo come in.
But I just wonder if this is a situation where some people are going to end up out of work because of this, because the game's winding down, or if everyone has other projects to roll onto. I'd imagine that there's so many games running.
What else is SOE doing at this point, though?
They're doing a lot of free-to-play stuff, I think.
Like, the Station Pass includes 15 games. I don't even know how many. Like,
oh my God, that is disturbing. Is it like boxers?
SOE Diner Dash or something? I mean, like.
That's not funny.
So, for your SOE All Access Pass, which is, if you buy it, it's $20 a month, but they do discounts if you buy it in bulk. You get, let's see, you get Free Realms, which is free, Star Wars Clone Wars Adventures, which is free, EverQuest 1, Planetside, EverQuest 2, DCUO, EverQuest. EQOA for PlayStation 2?
Apparently DCUO Austin is absorbing all of the Star Wars Galaxy staff.
Ah, okay, great.
Ah, okay.
All right.
Well, you know, EverQuest 2 went free-to-play.
So there's a couple guys that are here with us on the server right now that are QA there.
Great. Mm. Oh, that's just good to hear that they were able to find homes. Pirates of the Burning Sea and Vanguard are all part of the all-access pass. So
probably like 7 out of those 10 are probably free-to-play at this point.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, a large chunk of them are.
It's fine. I mean, MMOs have their lifespan. It's just this game can't go on forever. It's fine.
Yep.
Eight years is a pretty long time, though.
That's even the fact that it's always shutting down because of Tor, but even so, it's still, you know, obviously a good lifespan for an MMO.
Yeah.
Look at this fucking desert.
Look at that walk. Just fierce in the desert.
Keep going. Look at these. Wampa's doing it here in the desert. Not Wampa's, sir. How you doing, Ryan? Feeling okay? Have you taken a break at all since we started? Underneath your seat is a very wet spot, I assume.
We're going to need a new green screen, you guys. Vinny, I'm sorry.
It's going to be a yellow screen now.
Yeah, we're going to need to start keying it to a different color.
Green, yellow and green goes with blue?
Green, yellow,
what is,
blue.
What's green and brown do?
What is that reference to?
That's, it's a poop joke.
Poop joke.
That's what we're at here.
Well, we've got 40 minutes left.
I know.
Vader looks like he
42-ish, I guess.
Vader's really sassy with that walk. Yeah. That's a really sexy walk. That's what I'm saying. He's got the whole hip shaking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who did that? Why is he like that?
I think you're wearing a costume, right? Are you actually like a slave girl or you're a Twilight?
No, I'm a Rodian smuggler.
No. Wow. You look
smuggling
like a,
something.
Your dance looks like a Twilight dancer. I don't know why.
Oh, crap.
Yeah, where'd I come from?
Rebel Assault Force has successfully destroyed the Endor shield generator.
Go! Blow it up! Blow up Death Star 2!
They can now.
Yeah. I'm saying you should go. Perry, question for chat.
Yeah. Laid out.
Nothing yet.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's an excited chat, then, huh? I have a question for me.
Yeah. You in the back, you have a question.
I forgot.
What's wrong with this gin?
It's working.
It's not inside you. That's the problem with it.
I still want to come to Petaluma sometime else. We should do that. We should work it out right now. Actually, this.
Come on, let's go.
Yeah. What's your address again, Ryan?
I mean, you're not going to drive there, so we're taking you with us.
I gotta go to a movie tonight.
Nope. We can see it in Petaluma. What are you saying?
I have to go
what are you
seeing? See Sherlock Holmes tonight.
Dude, you see it in Petaluma. We can see it in D-Box.
I need to see D-Box for Sherlock Holmes.
Yes, I know. I love that. That's the movie that is supporting it.
We got
Mission
do
Impossible.
Stuff.
Talking about movies, though. So Alex saw.
No one's talking about movies.
Girls and Dragon Tattoo.
Yeah.
He went to the premiere, like the New York fucking premiere. He went
right.
To the, he saw it on Twitter.
He
the after party with Daniel Craig. And
all I heard was Tony Danza. I stopped right there.
That was enough for Jeff.
My eyes rolled back in my head and went.
The weird thing is, Alex actually volunteered to see Chipmunks 3 this weekend. I'm kind of scared for him at this point. I think he kind of gets off on doing the shitty reviews now.
Oh, he always has. I mean, he put reviewed Blackwater for the site today.
Which I didn't. I made a joke. I saw him say, "Oh, I'm gonna review Blackwater on Jive." I made a joke. Well, that's a really shitty company too. I had no clue that the company
totally
actually told them to make that game.
Yeah.
Like, whoa.
Yeah.
Even though they're not even called that anymore.
Nope.
Like, why would
right.
they?
Mm-hmm.
I don't
that's,
get
that's
that.
That's still the name people know.
They changed their name twice, and they're still like making a game called Blackwater.
Well, I imagine when that game was first supposed to be made, that was maybe not the case.
It was the case that they gave them, and you can obviously change the name of the game if you really want to. But but again, that sounds like a great deal. $50 for a 90-minute game that barely works.
That sucks ass. Through a chain-link fence.
They'll sail. I've never heard that one before.
It's the worst way to suck ass.
It's a bad way to suck ass.
Yeah. I mean, you can do it.
Through a paper towel.
I don't know if anyone's noticed this, but this giant tree is appearing out of nowhere on Tatooine.
That's actually a character play.
Yeah, is that a person? Is that tree a person?
No.
Is that Morpheus?
There's magic trees.
Magic tree is straight spitting.
We stopped playing. We're playing the fountain now, the game.
That's Lord British.
Oh.
Cast firewall.
And hey, look.
You saw that he's in talks now with
something
Garrett's
is fucking horribly, terrifyingly wrong with Lando.
I thought they sued. I thought he sued
hey,
AA for a lot of money.
Look at Lando.
I don't know that he won.
Oh, what happened to Lando?
What is wrong with Lando?
He got lost a fight or ate.
He is super high.
He's making bong motions. You got one of these, bro?
I think he's trying to play like a Jabba's Palace instrument, but I don't think he has one.
But look at his face. Forget that. Look at his face. Look at
3-footer, bro.
We're going to get sued for that, probably. John Williams is going to come for me.
Nah. You know what? I ran across this whole damn galaxy today. And other than this weird little oasis where Jabba's hanging out and everyone's being lunatics, God damn it, was it boring. Every capital city that I went to, every other planet.
Look at that ship.
I know! Look at the shit that's happening here! Well, see, now we're gonna get sued. Now, thanks to the SOPA, you've just shut us down.
SOPA. Yeah. Actually, they're, it's coming down now.
You've killed us.
They're gonna bring us down in 10 minutes for the actual server shut off.
Yeah.
Did you see
and they're shutting off Star Wars Galaxies because it's...
No, it's opening tonight. Like at 6.
It was showing at the Metreon last night.
No, it wasn't. Thursday night. Is
what was?
Mission Impossible.
Mission Impossible?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It starts tonight.
Really?
You're
I thought...
Wrong.
Okay.
You're basically wrong.
Okay. I saw on Twitter that
somebody might have saying, a secret or something.
Like a radio.
I hear it's pretty good.
Tonight is opening up 6 and 9, and they're going to have, obviously, the IMAX stuff all this week until next Wednesday or something like that. It comes out.
We had a lot of fun. I want to see that movie.
I do, too.
Well, everyone's saying,
I didn't see Mission Impossible 3. I was meant to.
It's pretty good. I think I hear this one's really good. Apparently, Brad Bird does a great job.
So. Great. Well, everyone just wants to see it because of the Dark Knight trailer. But only in select theaters.
But we have one. If you're curious to know if your IMAX screen is going to have...
Yes.
Oh,
hey, guys.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
This is the way the world ends.
Check this out.
There's a big ass fucking Rancor trying to get there, too.
That is so hot. Oh, the Rancor shoving it in there.
Vader just likes to watch.
Look what I have done.
Gaze upon my works, you. Fair.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about it. No, I know exactly how I feel about this.
Oh, he's twisting it around, too.
Yeah.
That's an advanced technique.
That's one of my moves, man.
That's what you're going to go to Thailand for.
Nice.
Whoa! Oh! Graphic! Oh! Jesus Christ!
I'm gonna download this later.
Wow! It's inappropriate, Star Wars Galaxies!
I'm aroused, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Ripping the flesh.
Okay.
That's just like a pilot. Can't find it.
Walk away.
Sashay out of there, Vader.
And onto the flesh, we shall make the new world.
Whoa. Wow. Yeah, you know, there's just giant ships falling out of the goddamn sky.
Yeah, and so maybe the frame rate might not be optimal.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Who's that?
It's a lady.
Some Amish chick. Oh. I'm a girl! Like, is that the costume? Like, whoa.
Look at it
over here.
Nope. Down a little bit. A little bit down. Oh, my God! Oh. Han Solo ran right over you. Down. Oh dear.
The fireworks will stop soon.
About half an hour.
Yeah.
That's a Bob Dylan song, I think.
About half an hour?
Yeah. Oh dear. Then that guy fucking crashed. Everybody's trying
to get
still,
this is how this guy's gonna spend the next half hour. They figured out you could totally hump the Sarlacc pit, and now this is the way it ends.
Well, once you can do that.
Get in your ship, man. Get up there.
I should go and get mine?
Yeah, look at all these ships up there. You gotta get up there with them.
What's the biggest ship you can pilot in this game?
Any of these ships that you see that are flying around here and jumping into the ground, those are player ships.
You can't have like a starter story, can you?
No.
Oh, that's too bad. Any questions from the chat, Perry?
Some people are wanting to know what would you think about a sort of Skylanders MMO where your profile is saved in a character and each piece of armor equipped and weapon on the figure is seen in the game.
Oh, that's actually not a bad idea.
I think there's a way to make that work. Mm-hmm. It's one of those things you have to balance really carefully because it'd be real easy to have the business stuff get out of whack with it.
Skylanders is one of those figures.
Yeah, on and stuff like that. Yeah.
Well, WoW had actually really cool. There was a business that came up that you could print your character out, like a 3D
right.
model.
Yeah,
remember that one?
Ed Freeze, mm-hmm. one of the founders of the Xbox, was running that company. Yeah, or still is, or I don't know what the
Cool.
And then they sold the plush figures or the plush dolls or whatever in the Blizzard store that then had a code key that you could use to get those as pets in the game.
Huh.
Which I thought was kind of a neat cross-media thing.
You ever heard of the WoW, the new pet you can sell that it takes $100 you can sell in the auction house? Have you heard about this?
No.
So to combat gold selling on WoW, Blizzard basically started selling a pet for $10. And the thing is, it wasn't bound to you when you got it. It was something you could actually sell again on the auction house. So the thing is, people would buy it for $10 and put it on the auction house and get, you know, sell it for 5,000 gold.
Right.
And it was a way they were trying to undercut the gold selling market.
Yeah.
So you pay $10 and just sell it for whatever, how much gold you can get on the auction house.
Right.
And if you did that, you could theoretically get a better exchange rate than what you could buy on a gold selling site. So and they're theoretically probably going to do it every like couple months. They're going to have a new one come out. Mm. Whoa, this is unexpectedly becoming beautiful. Oh, it's the Titanic music, that's why. Makes everything beautiful. You could put this over like a monkey flinging poop at new visitors, and it'd be like, it's
Just put a little slow motion, Titanic
put
music.
Put it under all of Dunstan checks in.
Anything Matt LeBlanc is involved with, you can just go ahead. And
Matt LeBlanc is not in Dunstan checks in.
Who's in that?
Jason Alexander.
Okay. What's
and Paul Rubens.
What's the Matt LeBlanc monkey movie?
Ed?
No. That was the Whoopi Goldberg monkey movie. No, maybe it was Ed.
That's right.
You're right.
I think Titanic was basically the best monkey movie of them all.
Ryan, so it's my favorite body swap comedy for sure.
You going to see it in 3D?
What?
Titanic?
If forced to, yes.
Your cupcake lady will probably make you, right?
There's a chance. We've discussed it.
When's that out? Is that out?
No, it's coming out in, I think, April or something?
But I have promised to take her to go see Sherlock Holmes in D-Box, so.
Get that girl some D-Box.
Well, yep. I'll let you know tomorrow. The review will be up by noon, I believe.
But you won't be able to tell me about the D-Box experience.
I won't.
Sorry. What do I care? What good is your review to me?
We only write reviews of D-Box. I think that's Ryan. You should actually just start writing up a series of sub reviews that are just about the D-Box experience.
Put them on. If you ever want to wear something for a screen, Ryan, I know people would love to hear it. Yeah, actually, if people on the
oh
chat
no!
Right, if people in chat right now want to ask request for Ryan to do a D-Box column on screen.com, send an email to ryan@giantbomb.com.
I'd be happy to, except they don't happen very often.
D-Box happens anytime you want it to happen.
No, D-Box only happens when they program
the
for
support
it.
Support is perhaps. Saw Fast Five and D-Box.
So I've seen Fast Five and
Tron.
Tron D-Box. Did you see Tron D-Box?
No, I sat in D-Box seats for Tron, but they were not turned on.
I saw Real Steel in D-Box.
Oh, obviously, yes.
Which was great. That was fantastic. Fast Five was better.
While we're on the subject of movies, though, you guys are obviously doing the Game of the Year stuff right now. Real quick, what is your movie of the year? Both of you. Favorite movie of the year. Favorite movie going experience of the year.
I didn't see a lot of stuff. Was Fast Five this year?
Yes.
That was May.
I saw that. I saw In Time.
Which was not great.
No. That might be all I saw in theaters.
Wow.
So Fast Five, movie of the year. Which wasn't going to be that anyway, but.
If I wasn't just absolutely enchanted by Hugo.
I heard Alex fucking loved it too.
Hell of a movie. They
don't
did
use the word love on this stream.
Scorsese did something pretty impressive with that.
I've heard a lot about Hugo. I want to see it. If I say something not Oscar nominated, I would say I think Harry Potter, Deathly Hallows Part 2 was 2 hours super well spent in a 3D IMAX theater. I was in tears for most of it. Just the end of that whole saga.
See, that was also in D-Box. That was the movie I missed that came out in D-Box.
Would have been good to see. How would they do like a wand battle in D-Box? Like a lot of little tiny vibrations or like a
It depends. It's like sometimes they're mimicking camera moves. Sometimes they're trying to convey some other motion that's happening. Like they kind of just choose shot for shot. Like the best moments seem to be the ones where they just kind of follow the camera.
Yeah.
Like give you a little tilt when the camera's moving in that direction.
Yeah, there's like flyovers and stuff of monuments in Fast Five where like as they're kind of tilting, like they'll tilt the seat for that and kind of lean up and over as it goes up.
Yeah.
Which is like a weird thing to think, like you're going up, so it's tilting kind of up in this way. But actually, it was relatively effective in the scheme of things. Oh, Jesus.
Well, it's like the old, you know, the old school 3D stuff where you have the head. What am I thinking of?
VR.
The stuff where your glass.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Virtual reality.
While we're on the subject of Star Wars Galaxies, that is. Oh my God! You're on that planet. That's lava.
No, it's a loading screen.
Nothing but lava.
It's just a loading screen.
Can you hump the lava? Dance in the lava.
I don't think I have any lava.
You're lava.
What he said. I'm with him.
Four is lava. How you doing, Andy?
I'm good.
You feeling all right?
I'm good. Yeah.
How's your life been?
It's been all right.
All right. You haven't been talking very much. I'm sorry if I'm like dominating.
No, that's okay. I'm contemplating my drive tomorrow.
Where are you driving to?
Pennsylvania.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
So you're going to be back Monday, though, right?
Yes. Yes.
That is, what, a two couple days drive?
It was
3,000 miles, so.
Yeah, we'll do it in about
probably
40 hours,
yeah.
42, 44 hours, something like that.
Damn, man. The longest drive.
Except I guess the weather at some point will get a little nasty, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, I did the 7-day forecast yesterday. It looked okay.
Cool. Obviously, that's 100% accurate, too.
Yeah, exactly. It's solid. So.
Longest drive I've ever done myself, and I learned to drive when I was 27. Longest drive I've ever done is here to LA. That's the longest time I've ever driven my car.
That's probably, I went to Vegas once. I guess that's technically longer in hours than here to LA. Mm-hmm.
Really? You're here to Vegas? Yeah. What do you think? Because
you have to get to LA to.
Yeah, you gotta go most of the way to LA and then cut east.
Yeah, I just wasn't sure. But no, I never learned. I grew up in the East Coast. I never learned how to drive. Was a happy biker, cyclist. Mm-hmm. But when I had to move down to Orange County, had to learn how to drive. So.
Need a car in LA, that's for sure.
Need a car in Orange County, that's for sure. And the problem is you can't really go out and have fun with your friends because you got to, hey, I'm going to go drive to, 20 miles to go out and drink, and then 2 o'clock, shit.
Spin donuts in this parking lot, so I'll sober up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to tell stories about that stuff, but I learned how to drive down there, or I learned how to drive in San Francisco, and I moved down there, and I drove a lot when I was down in Orange County. Came back here, sold my car, first thing I did, or the first thing I wanted to do. Yeah. I did it a little bit later. I was lying.
Yeah, that's your grandfather's truck.
Yeah, don't tell them actually. They think I still have it. They actually want it back. So, no, that's not true. They don't. They're weird about their property. But if you live in San Francisco and you work in San Francisco, you don't need it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're a Jawa. You're a Ewok. You're a pineapple.
Yep. Yes.
You're a pineapple.
You're a
cantaloupe. He's adorable.
Flying around.
Oh, I pet him so much.
Why are there flying Ewoks? What the hell's going on?
He's a Neimoidian Ewok.
If this was the Star Wars that they had, I would be way into Star Wars.
Punctuated evolution, sir. That is what's going on here. Oh my God. He's got a heart. He's got a Care Bear heart. He's got he's a Cupid. He's got arrows.
Oh.
Okay, he's a Cupid Ewok.
I want to fire.
Yes, exactly.
Truth is out there, flying Ewok. Don't you worry.
I'm so happy I'm here for the end of this.
Got
20 minutes left, right? 23 minutes left for Star Wars Galaxy.
X-Files, game of the year.
X-Files dubstep remix makes Trackmania 2 game of the year.
Well, apparently the Ewok does not have a dance animation.
That's unfortunate.
I thought it, like,
that's racist.
Your dance animation on top of
it's totally
we're
racist.
We're going to sue this game
out of existence.
Yes. Get my lawyer on
Don
the couch.
Johnson.
My lawyer Johnson.
Why is Bib Fortuna so small?
Because I'm huge!
No, you're not!
He's fine. He's normal sized.
You're normal sized.
Oh.
What'd you do? What'd you just do there?
Do you think they'll do the Matrix thing at the end where everyone just
throws them? Oh my God, you're a flying Ewok, man. You're a flying Ewok, Cupid.
Yeah!
Shoot somebody with an arrow of love. Take a ball of love.
I'm gonna fight this fake Boba Fett.
He's an obsidian Boba Fett. He's a black Boba Fett.
Come on, Calvin. Let's go.
Obsidian.
Punk ass.
It's a color, not as a video game company that you should work for. I thought I told you about that.
Did you work for Obsidian? Really?
We were talking about that earlier and how you ruined KOTOR 2, personally.
That was before my time. Thank you very much. I ruined Alpha Protocol.
The Storm of Zaheer.
If you guys want to hear about it, still a fine. You can find it on Steam now too.
I purchased a copy of that.
People are getting kind of antic here, frantic.
Yeah,
it's antsy.
It's like people are kind of waiting to see if something's like. Do you think something's gonna happen at the very end?
I don't know, but there are a bunch of Ewoks with gift boxes over their head down here. Yeah. Ewok children that are being killed.
I think I made up a word there. Oh, antic. Geez. It's like a mix of antsy and frantic.
Is somebody
antic.
Shitting all over
antic?
The desert?
Is that a word
antics.
Already?
Yeah, antics.
Antics. Okay. Well, is antic a word already?
Like antic. I mean, antic is the singular of antics.
Help Ewok. Help Ewok child find his lost Festival of Love cards. I accept.
Oh my God, Big Ewok!
What about all the gifts?
Your gift. I'm gonna go get a bonbon. I'll be right back.
I've got one right here.
In your pants?
No, on the table. You could have this one if you want it, but I have to feed it to you.
Oh,
one.
Them's the rules.
Oh, those are the pop.
It's good to have rules.
Yeah.
I'll be right back.
Charger Beaks will fight you.
There are now over 6,000 people watching this.
Fantastic. Welcome.
Certainly more people than that are playing the game.
Yeah.
Maybe. Maybe not.
Well, it looks like there's probably 150 people here with you.
Yeah, maybe something like that. And then, I mean, there are multiple servers running, so you have to imagine every server is probably somewhere around similar population.
Maybe.
Are you street passing over here? What do you?
Find me too.
Find me too.
You can do combo attacks.
What?
You can make people team up with other people. I have hired you several times.
Am I any good?
Level 7.
All right.
I said I was going to be right back, but nobody's leaving.
Why would they? That caramel looks gross.
Yeah. You're not even paying attention. You're playing your GBS.
What'd you call it?
Yeah, that's what it's called. I was going to fight about the name of the GBX.
Mike's. How you doing, Perry?
It's an invalid target.
How are you?
Can we all just say hi to Perry for being in the chat for like 8 hours?
Perry, how's the chat going?
I'm a Perry denier.
I like Perry. I think Perry's...
Well, technically, all he said was that we had to say hi.
Hi, Perry.
Hi.
No.
How's the chat going? Any questions at all?
Is there any Star Wars dubstep worth listening to?
Probably.
Probably. I bet that's
There is a Bill Cosby dubstep.
Yes, the Bill Cosby dubstep is impressive.
As a user pointed out today, that he sent that link along.
Great.
As we perpetuate that, I don't have to look for dubstep anymore because...
It just comes to you now.
I get plenty of recommendations on a daily basis.
Here's something terrible for you. Like, great.
Here's a nightmare scenario.
The Bill Cosby one is pretty well done. Yeah. And I was glad you watched as long as you
because
it was.
Sit over here,
it doesn't go to the heavy drop. It's about 2 minutes in.
Right. Like having
and all of a sudden, Bill Cosby goes, I tried to send it to Ryan, and he refused to click on it.
I actually ended up eventually listening to it. But I was like trying to do like three different things at that moment, and you send me a YouTube link to a dubstep video. I'm like, if I watch this, nothing gets done.
Hey, guys.
That's true.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Wub, wub.
I'm a spider robot.
I
Oh my god!
I see what you're saying.
Spiders.
Kill it with fire. Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha. I have to change because my spider robot took an arrow to the knee.
Nuke it from orbit. It's the only way to be sure. Ha ha ha. Ha ha.
That's really good stuff.
Oh my god. There.
Yeah, I know. I'm getting the
man,
high
brow.
Man,
where do you
right
get
here
this stuff?
It's
where do you come up with this?
Actually, Screen just has this document that they share with...
But
where's Matt Lurie and what have you done with him?
All funny of our stuff dot text. all the articles on Screen are procedurally generated from a spreadsheet. So
you just used Bethesda Tech.
It's the Radiant Quest system.
Rough.
Turned into
rough.
What?
Rough stuff.
What?
Yeah,
Radiant technology is pretty cool. Handcrafted.
That's actually
a really nice compliment.
The dungeons actually work pretty well.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Is that,
oh my
is
god!
That a breakdancing thing over there? What's going on?
Oh god! You should be in the cantina.
That's like a spider yeti.
No, he's in the cantina bar. This character's from the cantina, but I forget his name or his race.
Sure. Why don't you start using the IGN headline generator for movies, though? And then it could all just be like, should The Empire Strikes Back been a romantic comedy?
10 things you need to know about this, the Sherlock
about
Holmes.
About Martin Scorsese.
What Star Wars could learn from Star Wars.
Actually, that sounds like a real headline.
Yeah.
We're terrible. We're making fun
of people. This guy can dance.
Oh, yeah. Noel, that's being generous, but
he can leave his friends behind.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you're all going to leave your friends behind.
This is totally a Twilight dance. This is great. Me and Jabba's Palace. This would be the first person to get killed in
Let's
Jabba's Palace.
Let's call it 18 minutes here by my laptop clock. Man, the time flew by.
Dude Baca. That's a great name.
Yeah, we've been rolling with Dude Baca called in earlier. We've been rolling out with Dude Baca.
Yeah, Dude Baca's the white
Dude
Wookie.
Dude Baca is a white Wookie with a sick-ass yacht.
Should we try to take another call or
something? Oh, he's that guy?
Yeah, he's got a space yacht.
Is when you were typing in all caps for 6 hours last night?
Yeah. Yeah, that was him.
He was the one typing in all caps to your Twitter
Well, we were
account.
Both typing in all caps because we were both fucking completely stoked about everything that was going on.
Perry, what's the general tenor of the chat? Give me just take the temperature.
The tepid. Is it tepid? Is it hot? Is it cold? I mean, there's a like
a warm.
I want to look at this hot check. Second cooldown, so you're otherwise right, it'd be pretty.
Okay. Your cooldown.
I'm always looking for hot chat.
People are asking. Why so is Dude Baka an albino Wookiee?
It's best not to think about
it. Hey Perry, you want a cyber?
Can you do ASL?
What did that dude getting down?
Yeah. In this chat.
I know. Look at this one.
Yeah, let's get an ASL check on these guys before it gets too weird in this.
It's A-S-S-L.
What's going on? You got smoked.
How'd that happen? You got smoked by a tiny dude.
I have no idea what I got smoked by.
You know that dude right there
in front of you.
Yeah, the developer decided to activate combat without me knowing and iced me. Oh man.
Oh, is it all free for all now? It looks like everybody's getting kind of.
So is this like game over?
Oh dear. Oh!
No, this isn't. I'm just. I died. I got killed. I have to respawn.
Loading screen.
Well, for the next half hour, you could just.
Whatever, I could just close this and go, okay, it's down. Yeah, it ended. Sorry, guys, we're going to play dubstep for the next 30 minutes.
Whoops.
I don't apologize for that one.
Came out of a Bacta tank.
Oh, do you totally respawn in a Bacta tank?
That's what they do. They have Bacta tanks.
Well, yeah,
regenerate.
What happened to frames?
They went per second.
They shut those frames down.
Where did all the frames go?
It's frames per
those
minute.
Frames, they turned them off.
Frames per minute now.
I get my whip back here. Yeah, blow some shit up.
I do agree the general consensus that it'd be really cool if a Death Star just came in and blew up all these planets when the thing went down.
That would be cool.
What's that sound?
Server will be shutting down soon. Find a safe place to log out. 15 minutes left.
Find a safe place to log out.
What
dude.
Is that? What does that even mean?
Go straight into the goddamn sun.
Are there non-safe places to log out?
Yeah, well, make sure it's safe.
In case they bring it back up at some point in the future.
You
gotta
like contract a virus that goes into the Old Republic?
Yes, you wouldn't want to bring that with you.
Actually, maybe the if the team is embedding viruses to go into another MMO. To purposely wreck another MMO.
Can you go over that? Then they would still be up.
I think your Old Republic character should have a "I survived Star Wars Galaxies" T-shirt.
Yep.
The ending of.
Yeah. Or just doesn't have to be the ending.
What are you? Just hanging out, looking at.
14 minutes.
Okay, I wasn't sure if it had locked up or not.
I'm just flying into the sun.
Oh, okay, all right. Yeah.
I'm trying to find a safe place.
Did reality just lock up?
I don't know. Maybe.
You should probably be on the ground for the end of this, though, Ryan.
Is there a recommended place that you should go? Like, is
somewhere safe?
Well, like is it brown? Maybe in the brown part.
Where are you going to be when something happens?
The brown part is like the
Sarlacc pit. It seems to be where everyone.
Yeah,
is
I'm gonna go back into the Sarlacc pit.
That's is that the part of the brown?
How are you figuring that out?
Well, this is the ground.
The brown.
Oh, so I get closer to the ground before I can worry about anything else. Really.
Can you eject from here? Can you just like you Saints Row it?
I could, but that wouldn't really do me any good.
So I'll stop now.
Okay, here we go.
Just fast travel.
I'm living in a long time ago.
Autopilot
doing
two.
Something mean to it. 13 minutes. That was a short minute, I think. That was actually a really quick minute.
They want to knock off a little earlier.
Yeah.
People are telling Ryan to look at the PM. It was sent.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't know.
Sounds
what?
Dirty.
Private message or something. They're saying, like, go back to the party or, like.
I'm returning to the party.
Yeah.
I'm doing it, Perry!
Get to the party, Richter! See you at the party. I messed that quote up. I'm sorry.
You did. You put two together.
I did.
I transferred. And see you at the party, Richter.
Is it going to be in the new Total Recall? Like, how much stuff do you think they have to... the new Total Recall, you got to have three boob one. The Total Recall remake.
Why not make it four?
Yeah, is that you got to top it now. You got to top it now. Maybe five, even.
Sure.
The 21st
century. So it's still a number. You want...
I don't know, that's a Len Weissman joint, right?
Yeah, so it's not gonna be good, but you have to do.
Bryan Cranston is in it as the villain, right?
Yes. Yeah, he plays Coey again.
He's the. I don't think he's on the ground though. I can't tell if he's Cohagen or if he's.
I think he's Cohagen.
Okay. No Mars at all in that movie. Yeah. There's no Mars. It's all sun on Earth. So.
Where do you get your ass to then?
You don't get your ass to New York apparently, or New New York, or Neo New York. I don't know. There's no Mars. Sorry.
Who was the guy?
Why would you do that?
How do you?
Quaalude is the guy in the stomach, right? Quaalude. Yeah. I don't think he's in that. I don't think they're mutants either. You can't give people air.
Well, then what are you remaking?
Yeah.
Apparently the book, like the book that was based on, I don't know.
The book that was based on the movie.
Yeah, it was. The movie came out first, and then the book came out.
So it's an adaptation of the novelization of.
That sounds like a recipe for success.
But without
the canceled
Mars.
Adventure game based on.
Yeah, people are saying a developer PM'd you and.
Yeah, I'm back.
Developer PM'd you. That's serious. How do they know that though? Like how would they?
I guess they're seeing.
Well, the developer
on the screen.
Should just be able to warp him to them.
Yeah. Yeah. I saw the message. I was just already on my way.
Oh, okay. Huh.
What does it say?
Thanks.
Read the message out from a developer. Read it out.
Yeah. It was the guy who killed me.
So hang Fuck out him. Here, then. Jesus Christ.
This is where it's gonna go down.
Yep. Why did he kill you then? That's a dick thing to do.
Why wouldn't he?
Well, I would too if I was somebody.
He knew how much time Ryan would have to get back here. Oh, Jesus.
LOL is what Ryan says. You should find a way to turn off names.
No.
Is that a dead Jedi? Is that the blue guy over to your right? Is that a Jedi ghost?
Yeah, it's the ghost of Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obviously.
It seems like a lot like Second Life at this point.
Well, are there flying dicks yet? I'd love to see. Oh my god, that guy is.
What if?
Yeah. What if that's
this
the.
This is how the world ends.
Yeah, exactly. Was it 10?
Oh, I just got killed again.
Great, come back there again.
By a Jawa savage.
I don't think the developer knows.
I think they've just turned off everything, and so everyone can just fight everyone now.
Oh, no, but you get right back up, so.
Well, that time again. So there's like different. There's different levels of like death and incapacitation in this game.
Well,
so you get knocked down.
You get back
but
up.
But you
again.
Get up.
Damn it.
Size so quick. Chumbawamba. Can't get pretty up early in the morning. Get me on Chumbawamba.
Can you shoot someone now?
You can shoot someone now.
Are you too good for Chumbawamba?
Look at that texture. Wow. Oh, there. Okay, so that's better.
No, I guess not. I guess I'm not too
good. No, the texture's really shitty now, actually. But that texture is really good now. But oh my god, what the fuck are you? That the texture's really bad now. That's really good now. It's really bad now.
No, it's really good now.
That's really good now.
There we go.
There it is. It's great.
What's the time say there? Is it
9 minutes?
That matches up with my.
All right, that's all sync watches. Back here at 9 o'clock p.m.
Synchronize. Parker Lewis can't lose.
Hell yeah!
Womp, womp, womp.
Just every day I'm shuffling.
Pizza place is gonna close if I don't get there. I only got 9 minutes to get there.
Gotta get to the hot wings place. The wing stop will stay open for me. They know I'm coming. I'm a good customer.
Is that just an energy man? That's from Star Trek, Superman 4, right? Energy man? Who am I thinking of? Superman 4? Nuclear Man? Who's the bad guy in that movie?
Yeah.
Nuclear Man?
Yeah.
I think this is like the concept video for this MMO.
Well, you can play as a Jabba the Hutt, or you can play as a Han Solo. All the characters will be represented.
In all sizes.
Yeah.
We don't
Wouldn't that be better?
They just played the cantina music and then they got $80 trillion from whoever to make the game.
Like, go ahead and create all the art assets and make, like, some original stuff. But if someone wants to just be fucking Jabba the Hutt.
Just sitting around counting gold.
I'm a level 7 Jabba the Hutt.
Yeah.
My skills include shuffle.
eating.
Level 7 Pizza Hut.
I want the Spaceballs MMO.
Does this game have a slash pizza like EverQuest 2 once did, where you could order pizza through the game?
Does it just turn you into Pizza the Hut at that point?
It's Jabba that I just covered in pepperoni.
Yeah.
Does Jabba have a dance?
Yes. Is there a slash dance for
Jabba
Hut?
There is. There is. It looks like it. Yeah, do it again.
No, I haven't done it yet.
That's it, right there. Look at that. Oh. No, do it again. Do it again.
I'm dancing.
See, that's a Java dance.
What if you do slash pizza?
It probably says, hey, fuck you. This is serious Crash. Business.
No such command mood chat type.
You're on Tatooine. How do you want a pizza on Tatooine? You're crazy.
I'll serve pizza here.
I've had a lot of gin tonight. It's been great, guys. Love you all. Actually, I'm way more interested in reading this chat. That chat.
Yeah.
I want to know what what their last words are.
Yeah. Last words are, look at me, I'm Lando fucking Calrissian. Get this man a Colt 45.
Kempson Cash blindly feels at his surroundings. True.
Well, that's not true of us all, really, when you think about it.
This sucks.
That's true, too, of us all, when you think about it. Hello.
Oh.
Vinny's getting crazy. As Ryan's getting crazy.
What are you doing with this chat window?
Making it big. That's what she said. Fuck you, says Asador.
It's way clearer over here.
I don't have my glasses on. Bye. Wow, that goes pretty quick. That's going pretty quick. Oh, Lord, there's somebody spamming chat. Well, shit, that's going really fast.
You're gonna spam it.
I can't read that.
I'm not even gonna try. You guys are gonna look over that way. I'm gonna be the well-dressed gentleman over here looking right at the camera.
Gentlemen, ladies.
Solus kisses Factroids gently on the lips. What happens? Do you actually kiss one of the other characters when you do
doesn't
that?
Doesn't necessarily have the animation, but if you have someone targeted and do the emotes, it targets the emotes at a person.
Like the
which
unknown.
Is one really fun way to harass people is just like kiss them over and over again. Some people get really bent out of shape.
Fuck you, SOE.
Lick my balls.
That's
well, that's
easy. Ryan, please stop typing that. That's not cool. It's a macro. I can't stop it at this point.
Yeah.
Once it starts, it can't be
stopped.
You
know, one time I got banned on WoW.
Yes,
for
what that guy says. He says, not like this.
Not like this.
We would.
So, not like this.
Not is like he this. Angry that he paid all this money for this many years? What is he actually angry about?
Right.
That you find yourself here on a Thursday night? Like, are you just upset at yourself? This is what your life has devolved to? Oh. Sorry, SOE, you didn't make this destined to be crappy MMO good enough for me.
Well, how much money do you think they made off of Star Wars Galaxies over 8 years? Probably
I'm sure it was profitable in the end.
Yeah. I mean, what is it, still $12 a month or something like that for all, however many thousand people they have? I say 1,000, that's probably a low ball estimate. But.
Kick not Joe from the game early.
Yeah.
That'd be the ultimate hardcore bullshit. Sorry, you don't get to see the Death Star blow us all up.
3 minutes.
I don't think anyone will. I think it's just going to end.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything
crazy
happening.
Yeah, with the server countdown, that's...
Can everyone fight everyone? Is that still happening?
No.
Is that still a thing?
No,
that was not what happened.
He'd be dead by now.
Yeah. I just want to stare at Lando until this is all over.
What if his face melts?
Who doesn't, really?
What if his face melts? What was it the Matrix did?
Like
everyone
away.
Curled up into a ball? Yeah, everyone kind of crumpled up into balls at some point.
Yeah. Like it was just an animation it defaulted to?
No, they crumpled up into data points.
It was a weird, like all their limbs kind of squished together or something. Mm. It was a weird...
Everyone compacted.
Yeah.
Well, they'll be back. When... Oh, my God. Fascinating. Oh my god, it's a big mouse droid. Wow, it's a really big mouse droid. He's bigger than a lot of things that should be mouse droids are.
I'm going out into the desert to die.
I want
to
die alone. You should probably stay here, dude. I don't know. You never know what could happen.
Get that thing.
That's a thing from the planet in episode two.
Episode three.
Three.
Not two.
Lick my poop chute.
Which you're three.
It's three.
Some people just can't keep it classy when
there are giant stormtroopers and...
I like how Lando's following me.
This is a heartfelt moment.
Now.
I am a leaf on the wind.
There you go. See? Some people...
Jam out some poetry. That's what you do in the last two minutes of a server.
And this other guy says, what does that even mean? Great. That guy wants to duel you. Dude wants to duel you.
Hold my hand.
Just bitch slap him. I mean, Jabba's gonna bitch slap us.
I don't believe there is a hand holding routine here.
Where's Lando?
Lando. Lando! Dude, Baca.
Yeah, there's Dude Baca. Thank you, Dude Baca, for all the fun.
Kratos Bane holds his arms out and offers a hug. I feel like that's the best you can do in this moment.
Here.
1 minute left. Come on now, everybody.
Look towards the sun.
I give Pasquale a hug. It has been done.
For all the acquaintance be forgot. And then,
and then I gave Dude Baca a hug. Oh my god! Oh my god! I think I've just been made super giant.
You are terrible. You are terrible. Oh! I am become
all you see is the front of my Jabba belly.
Destroyer of worlds. Holy shit! Go back to the main group and fucking run him over.
Come on, Unicron.
Are you jumping?
No, this is my new camera view.
Yes, yes, run him over.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Are those just server messages?
Yeah. I love you, Star Wars Galaxies.
That's just server messages now. Oh. We have 58 seconds. We got a fucking proper countdown timer now.
You are killing everybody. You're running him over.
They are just turning this in.
Get on board the Falcon, kid.
How do you get on the Falcon, kid?
It's gonna blow. It's a homage. It's a macro. You can't get banned for macros now.
Get banned with 45 seconds left in the game.
Fuck you, everybody.
See, that's what I'd be doing if I was one of the mods.
Yeah.
Just banning people to the very end.
No.
Yeah.
Dude, look at how giant I am. Holy shit!
Thanks for playing.
You can't
guys.
See how giant you are. You took away your. Can you zoom out anymore?
That's it. That's as far back as I can zoom.
Well, you're taking over the entire space of everybody. Keep on going back to the party. Go turn around, Ricker. Party Rector?
I'm starting to choke up a bit.
I'm starting to.
Here we go.
His computer's starting to choke up a bit.
Oh, God!
Tactical nuke inbound. Oh, that's just Nimbus Ghost Slayer.
Yeah. God damn, you're huge.
Oh. We'll be disconnected in 30 seconds to serve confirmation. Final save before shutting down.
Please find a safe place to log up now!
No! I refuse! Mm-hmm.
Who wrote that server message?
That's just the default server shutdown message, though.
How about this?
The same thing in EverQuest.
You had a long road and a ton of memories. People can hate all they want, but we love you.
That's right.
Somebody's hitting their key as fast as they can.
Someone play some Sublime.
Bye, Star Wars Galaxies.
Aww. It'd be really funny if it lasted like 5 more minutes after this. Not really funny. It'd be kind of dumb.
Connection to Star Wars Galaxies lost. Uh-oh. Let me reconnect.
Heil Hitler.
That's how it's gonna go, huh? That's how it's gonna end. Credits.
Credits.
Roll credits.
Not gonna log back in. What are you talking about?
Yeah, get back.
Oh.
Well, it's been real.
Create a new character.
Yeah, do it. Actually, that's a whole joke. It's actually they just reset all the servers. You can get back in.
They recommend that my character play in this galaxy.
Yeah, that one. Yeah. Quick!
Did you name your guy?
It's default. It's gone. He's gone. He's gone. It'd be fine. It'd be fine.
Like this is still sending it through the database. That's great.
Oh. Huh? Are we gonna be able to sneak into Star Wars Galaxies after it closes?
Watch out, that Perry. Don't get too excited. Any questions from the chat, Perry?
Nope. Everyone's just
excited, crazy. See no evil.
I don't think this is gonna do anything.
Well, you're gonna do something. You're not doing anything. That's a wrap on Star Wars Galaxy. Yay!
Yeah.
Good 8 years. Cheers to that. That's a long.
8 years. Yeah. That's a hell of a run.
Real that's long a thing roll. That mm-hmm. does not happen, and like most kids only live to 8 years old nowadays.
Yep.
Yeah, really most people don't make it to 8.
Yeah, yeah, it's really a hard situation to have. I don't have those legs. Those are not my legs. I feel so insulted by that. I'm going to get out of the way. Are you kidding me? I'm going to stand over here. I don't want those legs. I'm going to do this. You can all see my legs.
The legs below your legs are
I have really
jumpy.
Long legs, actually, so. Is that going to be really weird to... I have weird
legs going on. I'm gonna sit cross-legged actually.
And I guess with that, we say goodbye to Star Wars Galaxies. It was interesting to share the final hours of the game with you guys and everyone who played with us. Thank you guys so much. Thanks to Pasquale. Thanks to Dude Baca and everyone else who was on the Starsider server with us here in the end. It was bizarre and insane in all of the right ways. All the ways that I like an MMO end-of-world event to really work is just...
Right.
Throw all the craziness that you can find that you have, you know, stocked up or piled away somewhere, and just let the people have it, you know, go nuts. And yeah, I think it is important at the end, because regardless of how big the audience was, there were, and it was something that I kind of learned when we did the Matrix thing.
Right.
There are people that, you know, consider this a home. They go there and, you know, they hang out with friends and they socialize through that stuff. So even if it's not a huge group of people, and even if you know, the game itself is maybe not worth it.
Hey, don't be mean.
I'm just saying.
Hey, don't.
Qualitatively speaking.
No matter where you go,
there you are.
There you are.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's important to someone, right?
Yeah.
And that should be meaningful in some way. So thanks to everyone.
Gaming experiences are.
Thanks everyone at SOE who facilitated this and made it possible for us to do this. And
you are off the hook.
The QA folks who in the game who showed us some extra weird stuff. Our whole posse that rolled around the galaxy with us.
Thanks to Perry for.
Perry got up. Jeff, you've been locked down there for as long as I have. Yep. So
yeah. So Perry, you're not that.
Yeah,
cool.
Perry's not that cool. You were doing his job for a while.
If you didn't know, we had the whiskey holiday party today.
I did not know that.
And people in the bar, and we had pizza and stuff. And I wanted to make sure Perry got a little bit of a time to socialize and stuff. So.
So I guess we'll take a quick break. And Jeff, you and I are gonna swap spots or something. Are we done? What do you want to do?
Trackmania, woo!
Yeah, Trackmania, don't go down. Trackmania is forever. No, friend. You know, I was hoping that we would have gotten... I was told that today would be the day for us to get into Old Republic, but it didn't happen, so...
Well, who's to blame for that, really?
Well, there was someone in chat.
I could name a few people.
There was someone in chat who offered for you guys to use his account.
Nah.
I do have Diablo 3 beta, if you want to get to that.
We
have to download it, though.
But. Let's call this a night. It's late. Yeah. We've got people here who want to go home. We've got another action-packed day at Giant Bomb tomorrow. So thanks, everyone, for watching, and we'll see you.
Look at the camera. That's the way to look. Don't look at the TV.